Well, she had it coming, after all. Okay, I'll talk to you later. Make sure you hide the body. Lay low for a while. Well, hello there. I knew you were watching the whole time, and what I wanted to tell you right now is that you can't really do anything to put me in jail. That's just the way it is. Some justice cannot be served to most people, and I have a really, really expensive lawyer. I'm here to introduce you to the 2020 Dubbin Stuff special, where I'm going to show you a compilation of all the Dubbin Stuff that we've done so far. Let me just get my notes. All right, so there's over 2.5 hours of pre-recorded, pre-dubbed greatness for you guys to enjoy. So, well, let's go take a look right now.
There's no place like home. There's no place like home. Oh, man. Oh, this is my home?
Ah, blasted keys. Garage, boat. There we go.
Who are you?
And don't you recognize me, darling? I'm just wearing this hat. Hat, you glad I didn't say banana?
My hair's in the shop.
Well, your hair's clearly right in front of me. Sorry I barged in here unannounced. I thought the fact that you gave me the key in the first place means that I can come here anytime I want.
Well, I'm happy that you're here. It's just that my hair's not from the shop and...
Alright, that's enough about that shop. Can you just tell me? Okay, I'm sorry. I'll tell you next time I pop on by. Wait. Listen, I know you're not dressed pretty, but I think you're pretty. So be pretty and be pretty on my mouth and kiss me.
Oh, wow, you know how to rev up a girl's engine.
Oh, geez. I'm getting winded falling around this apartment. Do you mind if I take off my hat and throw it on this couch?
Well, no. Oh, it looks like you did it anyways.
Huh? You sure like to keep a dock in here.
Well, you know, it's the best way to play Fortnite in the dark. You know, adjust the lighting in your room and you have better lighting on your
TV. And you save a lot
of
power. Listen, honey, there's something I need to tell you, something.
Well...
I just think you're just swell. Let's get married.
No, I don't think so.
I'd be really good to you. Also, I have a boat.
How can one have moist and dry hands?
Because I'm simultaneously nervous and dehydrated.
I didn't know I was that kind of girl to have that effect on men.
You're my kryptonite.
I like your comic book reference.
I just know a few from the movies.
What kind of movies have you seen?
You know, like the big kind of movies that people like to go stand in line for and... watch and see and have a good time. Funny movies and sad movies and...
I prefer men who likes the Fast and Furious franchise. Because they have some great life lessons about family and...
And Corona?
If that's all you glean from this conversation, then this conversation's over.
I don't think it's over.
Well then fine, allow me to chastise you a little bit more about Fast and Furious. The Fast franchise is the best franchise that has ever existed. And if you don't believe me, then I want a divorce.
But honey, we're not married. Perhaps may I suggest we get married?
Not this again. Perhaps when we get married, we can get divorced afterwards.
Well, in this day, we can't just get divorced here and there. There's a huge process and everything.
Oh man, getting divorced is so complicated. But we should not get married just because we don't not like the same movies.
That's exactly the point. We don't have to like the same movies. We just have to like each other. Come on. I like you.
Did you like it? Was it my singing?
It wasn't not your singing.
You know, the law back in the 20s said that you can't kiss before marriage. But now we've kissed. So we might as well get married. What do you think?
Well, I don't know about that. That seems kind of stupid. You can't just kiss anyone.
Let me just find my handkerchief so I can cry. Oh, jeez. Okay, let me write something down for you. Well, there you go. It's an IOU for a kiss.
Okay. Don't kiss and sing.
Wow, that was quite the kiss, honey. I thought you didn't like me. You're quite the fickle lady, after all. I'm gonna go, watch Fast and Furious, if you don't mind. Yeah.
How dare you?
I don't want you to think less of me just because I haven't watched Fast and Furious. Just think less of me because I'm a jerk. I don't even close the door.
Oh, jeez. That's the last time I do online dating.
Thus concludes Dubbin Stuff. Enjoy it next time in the new Roaring Twenties.
Da-da. Stop. Hammer. Wrench time. Yes, that's right.
Dun-dun-dun. Bum-bum-bum-bum.
A cigarette shouldn't have this kind of smoke.
La-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la.
Is that a wrench in your pocket, or are you just happy to see me? Now you listen here. I got things to say.
Oh, don't you now? I'm sure you got lots and lots of things to say. But I want to know exactly what you have to say about certain things that brought us to this point. In fact, where are we right now? What is this?
Oh, can't you tell it's an auto shop?
Oh, come on, I need a straight answer. You need to tell me what's going on, or else I'm going to tell the police. Judging by the look on your face, you're scared. And when you're scared, you're going to be doing something drastic, which is why you have that wrench in your back pocket. Actually, never mind. You might be a stand-up guy after all. I like the cut of your jib. Oh, wait, hold on a second. You know what a jib means? It means your personality, your character. I like to rule this auto shop with an iron fist. You understand that, right? Perhaps we can be best friends after all. Maybe we can...
Oh, I forgot we have to pump gas for people.
Hold on a second there, kid.
You think you can handle it?
I'm handling it, ain't I? I got this, don't worry.
Wait a minute, what's that wrench doing in your back pocket? Were you gonna re-gift that back to me? Because I own that wrench. It's my wrench. You can't just re-gift a wrench to me. That's stupid. And don't walk away from me. I'm the...
Doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doo. Gotta do my job.
You get in the back seat.
Oh. I guess so.
You might be wondering why I got you here in the first place. If this movie was more white than black, you'd be able to see this gun. Have you ever heard the story of Darth Plagueis the Wise?
Man, I tell you what, things are going down all over town, I'll tell you what. So I was telling her what, I'll tell you what, and I told her, I'll tell you what.
You're getting the heck out of here.
Now listen, son, you're going to have to learn to ride a bicycle on your own from now on.
Daddy, no!
I'm not your dad. I'm your stepdad. And now I have to leave you. Goodbye.
Listen here, kid. You're not going to make it in the military. You're too flat-footed. Better luck next time.
Hi, I'm Thomas the Tank Engine. I'm here to take you away from your family.
I hope you're ready for college.
Oh, wait, I forgot. Which way to the cigarettes? Never mind, I'll find it myself. I'll be back.
Oh, man. You might not want to go in there. Haha. Chipotle.
I have no sense of smell.
You might be wondering why we're meeting out here instead of the office.
Well, you know, these office prices are ridiculous.
Hey, you might be wondering why I brought you here.
Wonder not any further. It's perfectly clear that you're here.
Yeah?
To do a job that needs to be done.
That's why they call me the job man. I can do all sorts of jobs. Good jobs, bad jobs.
We're looking for a good job.
Uncle Tony said we're looking for a good job. Think he can do it?
Of course. I might even do a better job if he decides to make eye contact with me.
I'm sure that can be arranged. After all,
I'm the one with the fedora. I make the rules, and you listen to me. The job I'm looking for is I need you to build me an ottoman. If it's not up to snuff, then I'll choose somebody else to do it for me.
How high do you want it off the ground?
Perhaps...
An adjustable one?
You are pretty good. When I put my feet up...
You want to be like, how high, right? This isn't an easy job. It's going to cost you.
I'm willing to pay any price.
Whoosh. Everyone shut up for a second.
Who's that lady?
I wouldn't worry too much about her. She's part of the plot, but we're not really talking too much about the plot details of this particular movie. So let's just ignore her.
I need to be avenged.
Wonder what happened.
I was hurt.
I'm not so sure about that.
Oh, wow.
Does she have anything to do with the plot? I wouldn't worry about her. Listen.
I don't think so. Isn't it sad when you see people being carted away like that? I want this ottoman done right, okay? No way am I gonna not have this done right at all. I want it adjustable. I want adjustable high, low, and all sorts of things. Well, I just want to remind you that once you get this done, it can't be undone. You're paying for a job, and I'm gonna do that job to the best of my ability. And if you don't like it, that's your problem. What did you just say to me? I think this is gonna be a great ottoman, don't you?
No.
Well, it's a chalkboard, that's for sure. But I'm more interested in what's on the chalkboard. Words, ideas, schemes. So, what's your plan? Because all I can see here is blood, hypo drugs, all sorts of things from left to right. It just doesn't make any sense.
Well, come on, you just gotta throw a couple ideas on the board and see where it goes.
Okay, let's figure out what the whole deal with the sick husband, Car Riverside. Alright, D. O. Dog. That's what spells dog. Alright, and this thing about...
So what you're trying to say is that this dog is a criminal? Perhaps maybe the cat gots the tongue. Oh, doctor? I thought you wrote a dog for a second there.
Well, the thing is about the dog is that it's not much of a suspect. A dog can't kill anyone with a knife, but a person sure can, I tell you what. And perhaps the doctor was trying to hide something. Maybe a mess up of a thing,
well,
a surgery. And
it's all just a hypothesis.
True that.
Well, and the thing is, you know, that's just...
Hypotheses are...
Go ahead. Go, no, you...
Well, since you're interrupting, go ahead.
Perhaps if we take the road less traveled, we can do some interviews and talk to some other folks. Maybe we can talk to the neighbors about where the doctor was.
Yes, that's a great comment. I like the cut of your jib. Perhaps we can talk a little bit more about this maybe over coffee. You don't look like you're too happy about that. What's so bit? Fine, avert your eyes. Maybe we'll just go to Riverside, ask some questions, find the killer.
I hope you're ready for this.
Oh, hey.
I think it's absolutely prudent that you remember that she's not actually sick.
Of course. Delusional people tend to be more dangerous.
Yes. But we have to play nice. Remember what happened last time? It was an absolute bloodbath.
Well, how bad could it be, actually?
You have no idea what you're in for.
You have a woman who's been bedridden for a month. How bad can she be?
Pamela's an absolute force of nature. Come on now. Don't embarrass me, okay? So I told him, I'm Pamela Beauregard. I shall not be ignored.
We're sorry. The number you have reached is...
Well, hello there, Gigi. And Steve, what are you doing here?
We came here to give you some support.
Ha! I don't think so, darling. I'm fine, thank you.
I've been led to believe that you've been taking any calls lately. I'm just checking in to see if you're doing just fine, but it seems like you've been in bed for quite some...
Please don't say time. I'm allergic to rhyming.
Now, doesn't that sound a little silly? After all, sound can't make you go into anaphylactic shock or anything.
It's a tickle of the ear. I find that hard to believe. Usually a prelude to death. But you wouldn't know, nor that you'd care. Why don't you just leave and leave those fresh rhymes at the door?
Okay, now Paula, you have to listen to reason. We're here
because
Paula
Beauregard to you, sir. And don't you forget it.
You know, I actually think you're sick.
Oh, Steve, no, don't, please, no, please.
How long have you been in that bed anyways? 1 week? 1 month? Maybe even longer? We're worried about you. The world is passing you by and all you can do is do your hair in bed? That's not right.
Well, maybe you're right. I want to go out, but I'm sick.
What do you have?
If I knew that, I wouldn't be here. How could you be so obtuse, standing there with your working legs?
The sickness has caused you paralysis?
Yeah, that's right.
Now tell me, how does that actually happen? We'd all love to hear it.
I'll be happy to. But before I tell anyone, Gigi, you my girl. I love you so much. You are the best. And I'm going to tell you exactly why the sickness has caused me to be paralysis. It was a winter's day. I was skiing in the Alps, and I realized that, wait a minute, something weird's happening down there, and I have to go inside the lodge and, well, you know, I might have pricked my finger on something. I just don't know how to explain it. But I'm sick, and I need all the help and support of my dear friend Gigi. And yes, maybe you too, Steve. You can help me. You can support me. Don't give me that look.
What's going on in here? You guys mess with my lady? She's my princess.
Please forgive them. They do not know of what they speak, after all.
And what do they speak, honey?
Please don't kill him on my behalf. I'm so innocent.
Oh, God. Let's get out of here.
All right, y'all, you all better be quiet. We got this lady up in here telling her a testimony up in here in the courtroom.
I may be a simple country lawyer, but I just need to ask you a couple questions.
You go right ahead.
So, like, what's your situation?
I don't understand these accents.
And what's that, madame? Is it because we'll probably just drop him in the end anyways?
Yes, of course. And watch your language.
Now listen here, madame. I got questions for you.
Please just call me Rosie.
Do you think these accents are dumb?
Whoa, whoa, I object!
Really?
This trial is a farce, I tell you. And I gotta say, it's very clearly. Without accents
like this
and accents like that, you won't be able to tell the difference between the voices in this movie. It's really quite clear.
Yo, I agree with that.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Alright, ma'am. You can leave. Who cares?
It's not like this movie is going anywhere anyways. I'm putting this movie on trial. Accents are made from the idea that a culture evolves to a point where slang becomes normalized, and therefore, a part of speaking patterns. I have brought for you three... Hold on a second, sir. These three are very important to my case. I'll be right back. Larry Moe Burley... No, Larry Moe Turley, Larry Moe Shemp. Come on, man. Make way. Are you seriously playing chess? Guys.
Now.
Yo.
You listen here. You play fair, okay?
Yeah, I'm playing fair. Ow! That hurt.
Ooh, my voice isn't that great.
Violence is funny.
Guys, quit fighting each other. This is serious.
Hey, you mean the court case?
My case is dependent on you. Yes, the case. Don't forget about the case. Come on, guys. Let's get going.
Booth Hillville. Population, various. Here we are going to join our heroes on their quest to be the best piano players ever.
Move over.
Let me play.
Listen, you twos. You gotta play like me. You gotta play like this. Alright, that's enough. We can't have more than three people playing the piano.
Ding!
The next broken key is your face.
Yeah, I like to play.
You gotta be more like a pianist. Like me. I'm a pianist.
You ain't no piano, man. You get out of here.
Oh, jeez, everyone's a critic, isn't that right, boss?
Yeah, he just doesn't like us three playing.
Oh, where'd he go? I guess I'll follow him.
Alright, you mugs, you wanna be the queen bee around here? You gotta listen to me. Now check out these dance moves. So dangerous. Quit laughing at me. I put myself out there. Well, perhaps a little contemporary dance.
I'll tell Curly to spread the word.
Y'all ready for this?
What did I tell you about talking?
I'm just showing your visual achievement of dance.
Well, stop it. I haven't finished wood shopping my dance move. I'm not performance ready.
Yo, listen. I'm calling you out. I'm calling you out. Come on. I got something special for you. Oh, I see how it is. You're a coward. I want to tell everyone that you're a coward. You hear me?
What was that?
Oh, gotta get out of here. Oh, no. What? How the heck did I get away over here?
What the? All right, Curly, you have an unfair advantage.
No, I'm going to show you good, partner.
No, please don't do anything to me. I'm only innocent.
Let me get this thing out of my pocket. Oh yeah! What the? Come on! come now. Yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah, I'm sorry, I'm sorry, I'm sorry. No. Oh, this gag is going on way too long.
Huh, looks like we finally beat the boss. There's a new sheriff in town, I tell you what. Oh, I'm so excited for an authoritarian government. What do you think, Curly?
Not so fast.
You're the sheriff?
Can't you read the badge?
So what you're trying to tell me is that this guy's the sheriff?
I guess.
It's time to tattail it out of here.
Excuse me, pardon me. Oh.
Will you quit beatboxing already?
Oh, jeez. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God. Please. Oh, God.
There they are.
Hello? This isn't a good sign. Guys, wake up. Come on, guys. I need your help. Guys, I need your help, please. This is urgent. I have money.
Yeah, you just said the magic word, boss.
Shut up.
I'm Shemp.
All right, you mugs, let's get to work.
That's right, boss.
We're detectives. We're dressed for bed, and we're dressed...
Guys, I just need your help, please.
Let me at him, Don't
boss,
you
don't
ever interrupt me again.
Our boss is crazy.
Okay, let me tell you about this case. A beautiful girl was kidnapped. I don't actually know her, but I just want to get to know her. But when she was kidnapped, I was just like, hey.
Icebreaker?
Precisely. I need a reason to talk to her. And
you got a real hero complex.
Some girls like it when you go the extra mile.
Champ once had a girlfriend. I ordered a sandwich and she brought it to me. It was very romantic. It was so nice. The sandwich tasted pretty good too, but then she charged me afterwards. Then I realized she was the waitress. Oh, that really hurt.
I really hate doing these things to you.
I got it.
Well, the more of the story is the heartbreak happens all the time.
Maybe a picture of a hot lady will distract you from killing each other.
You're absolutely right.
Now get out of here. You see what happens? If we rescue the girl, she'll love us instead of that guy. Wouldn't that be pretty
sweet? And
maybe
she's got a dumb older sister like you.
This is not the kind of meet-cute story I want.
Let me guess, you want to meet at a girl at a grocery store, you both reach for
is
something...
Is it so hard to look at somebody in the eye and instantly know that you're in love?
You remember what Mom said?
Touch the heart before you touch the butt.
That's exactly right. Come on.
What did I do?
All right, you mugs. We're caterers. That's who we are.
Can I be Swedish Chef?
I love Swedish Chef.
Blurk, blurk, blurdy, blurred, blurred.
Quiet. I think I can hear my patience running thin.
Sure we are in the right spot?
Now don't you be doubting me. We're right here where we're supposed to be.
Hold on, let me check the picture again. So this is the lady.
She's too skinny for me.
What do you know?
I could use a flashback right about now.
Oh, yes, my dear. We're going to practice so many things on you. Oh, see that gorilla over there? He's my best friend. Oh, we're going to do so many great things. We're going to put... Please don't interrupt me.
I'm scared. Oh, please save me.
Oh my God, do you think we're in a flashback of a flashback?
We are, yeah.
I think Christopher Nolan is overrated.
Overrated?
Can you believe this crap? Oh, jeez.
Excuse me, dears.
Crap, let's get out of here.
Okay, what's going on?
Look at this newspaper. 50% off 10-gallon hats. Not that, you idiot. Those boys don't have no respect for us. Porter? Huh. Perhaps if we catch this Porter guy, we'd be all sorts of rich. What do you say we go in there and get a drink? Ah, don't you get out of here. You don't want to mess with these boys, I tell you what.
No, I can't say for certain, but...
Oh no, these boys are right here, so you better watch out.
Darn!
I just want you to know that we're the rudest dudes cowboys around.
You don't say.
You better not mess with us, okay?
Yeah, I don't want any trouble. Come on now, let me buy you a
drink. Oh boy, let's do this.
Well, it's nice I can hold up a pint.
Alright, bottoms up! Oh, jeez. Are you okay? You look kind of funny with that whole thing.
Oh yeah, you know me. Oh, spilling.
Oh!
I like myself a tough man. Let's say you and I head upstairs.
Well, if you insist.
But first, let's all dance.
A one, two, three. A one, two, three. A one, two, three. I don't know how to dance. I just count a lot. Just let's all dance. Everybody is dancing. Woo! Oh, I'm sorry about that. Whoa.
It's okay, darling. Let's dance. Just keep dancing.
Woo! Oh, Fortnite dances. Fortnite. Oh.
Yo, God.
Oh, mea culpa. Let's get dancing. Come on.
All right, I got enough courage. You mind if I dance with the lady? Move aside. Larry, you want me to cut in?
Of course. Oh, do you come here this often? This is really fun. Let's dance some more.
I don't really like this. Get out of here.
Well, you better go check this out, Jim.
All that vagrancy.
So you're telling me these aren't the dangerous men I thought they were? I'm really gonna enjoy this.
You got stuff on your face, and just in case, you gotta get out of here. Boy.
Oh, yeah? Check this cold steel.
No.
You know what you guys are? You're charlatans.
Oh, yeah? I'll show you who's fat.
What did I say about playing with slingshots?
You're gonna have to get a real gun.
Let me... Hold on a second.
Well, misfires happened all the time.
Alright, boss. I lined them up. Check this out.
Alright. You're gonna have to really shoot them.
Hey, I'm pretty good at this.
Yeah, let's do it again.
Oh, wow. I can really curve the bullet. Did you see that? Check this out.
Yeah, check that out. Mind bullets.
Mind bullets, you see? What's going on with this thing?
Let's bolt.
No!
I have an upset tummy. Give me some Pepto.
Well, I say we cut him open.
Quiet, I'm trying to do my puzzle. Yahtzee. I think the table has it, dear. Can you do something about that spider? Okay, you're just gonna... I understand that locusts have a lot of protein, but that's not an insect.
It is the crab of the land.
Okay. Let's see if this one fits this time. Oh.
My tummy still hurts over here. Do you think you can do anything to fix my problem?
Oh, wow. More people.
Haven't you already done enough, honey?
Oh, wow. I can't wait to use our Airbnb as a cover to kill these people.
Well, aren't all Airbnbs a ploy to kill people when they least suspect it?
What about Airbnbs with high ratings? You can't torture anyone and expect them to give you a good rating on your Airbnb.
Listen, you torture them until you get the perfect score.
Does that really work? Ugh. And all I've been doing is eating spiders.
I like to think of it as a way as a inventive pest control.
Huh? Sure, it's taking them a long time to pull in.
So am I gonna have to put up the welcome wagon or you?
You promised me you'd take me to JCPenney's and Macy's.
Shut up. Looks like we're here.
Don't change the subject.
Come on, not this again.
Are we still talking about Macy's?
Well, it's not about Macy's, but we probably shouldn't say Macy's because it's copyrighted.
Not like this movie, right?
You know it.
Well, this is a very nice B&B. I can't wait to go in there and go shopping and look at the knickknacks and all sorts of things.
Hey ladies, I know it's a little late, but do you guys have any spare rooms for us? We have money! From the English pound to the Indian rupee. We're not going to stiff you on the bill.
Probably.
And I probably shouldn't have said that.
No. Nope.
We are definitely going to pay.
Okay, I can't wait to have you stay with us.
Let's take a good look at you guys. Oh, you're in pajamas. Perhaps this is a bad time?
Oh, no, it's a good time. Would you like two beds?
I can sense the negative energy in the air.
Two beds do sound nice.
You guys are a riot.
Shh.
Oh, I'm sorry. Am I being too loud? Well, I don't care if I'm being too loud. Come on, I'm going to be in the room. I'm going to be in words and stuff. Woo, we're going to party. We're going to have all sorts. Marches went down in Washington today when a really, really, really attractive girl became single.
What turned into a peaceful ask turned into a violent protest of who's gonna ask her out first. But then, violence erupted, with over 300 people getting injured and over 2 people getting killed. Officials released tear gas on the populace to disperse the crowd, but more violence erupted as a result.
Fires, property damage, all sorts of wonderful, terrible things. Oh my god, is that a bus on fire?
Whew, jeez, everything's going crazy out there, isn't it?
Officials in Washington have yet again failed to counteract, and officials on the street have to take arms against the rioters. Oh boy, here's my favorite part.
This is the part where it blows up.
Turn it off! You see that, Cabinet? We've become a laughingstock in this nation. We gotta figure out how we're gonna date this girl, or at least get her boyfriend. Ugh! Man, if it only was so simple to ask out a pretty girl, but no, we gotta be all sorts of like, oh, hey,
excuse
I like you.
Excuse me, sir, I'm sorry to interrupt, but we're working on a plan to ask her out as we speak. It's not uncommon for a pretty girl to end a relationship.
I remember the last time I dated a pretty girl. And she was pretty, like really, 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 really pretty. But this girl here, she's out of everyone's league.
I'm not looking for problems. I'm looking for solutions.
Well, perhaps if we send a nice bouquet to this girl, maybe she would be interested in dating us. I sent one to my wife many years ago before we got married. But of course, you know how things end up. You know, I talk too much and I don't ever listen. Well, long story short, our relationship ended on a low note. Listen, we're looking for something a little more long term here. We can't just wine and dine someone and expect it to have a longevity. We have to be very critical about our thinking when it comes to asking out this really, 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 really pretty girl.
Well, why don't we just buy them dinner and maybe they would
be indebted
to us?
A pretty girl must be earned, not bought!
Whoa, move aside, guys. The military's up in the his house. Ugh, what can you tell us about our strategy?
Well, to understand exactly who likes this girl, we have to think about the regions in the world exactly who actually likes this.
As you can see from this pie chart, the yellow indicates the amount of people gaining interest, and the black are the people who are riding to try to get this girl.
We might be in over our heads. And I would suggest a two-front strike. One guy would be like, hey baby, what's going on? And then a nice guy would come in and be like, hey, is this guy bothering you?
Well, all sounds great on paper. But in practice, this girl doesn't seem like she's that dumb. There's more to this girl.
I know you're like my commander-in-chief, but that kind of talk is treason. This new trend of being self-partnered is an abomination. Yeah, that's right. Yeah, look away.
So what you're saying is that the longer she's single, the more it's gonna stay that way. So what do you suggest we do?
Well, have you really considered all the options, bruh? Perhaps if we threaten to nuke her hometown. That way she'll have, like, no choice but to date one of us. You got it all wrong. As the only one here with experience dating a pretty girl, you still don't get it.
We looked at many options, but maybe the friendship option.
If that's your option, we might as well be strung up by her toes and tortured to death. You think that dating a pretty girl makes you better than us?
I've got out of the friend zone before. And I can do it again. You know what? I have a hard time believing that you actually got out of the friend zone in the first place.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Now you guys gotta get along.
Hello, hello?
Yes, I am happy with my long-distance plan. Sir, there's a guy attempting to ask this pretty girl out.
What's the situation?
Mm-hmm.
Oh no. Really? She said yes?
Okay.
Alright, guys. Just because she said yes doesn't mean she's not gonna date around. One date doesn't necessarily mean boyfriend.
But sir...
Oh, no, quiet. It doesn't mean anything.
Whoa. What do we do now?
$10 trillion down the drain.
Did you guys just hear me singing? That's kind of awkward. What do you think?
I don't think you're allowed to sing that
song.
Oh,
what do you know? I'm going inside. I gotta use the bathroom. Hurry, you fool! We gotta cover this up! My Bluetooth seems to be connecting to a weird device around here. Maybe I should go check it out. Oh no! If he finds my secret hideout, we'll be ruined! Come on, let's get out of here!
Sir, do you think about setting up an elevator? It's so difficult.
Alright, let's see what we got here. Uh-oh. The signal seems to get stronger around here. Let's see if I could find any kind of secret doors or secret contraptions.
Ooh, Winfred, you need to close the brick wall.
Huh.
Go, close
okay,
it.
Okay, I guess.
Just leave me alone.
Seem to be getting closer. Closer!
Winston, do this. Winston, do that. I'm always out of breath. I just can't keep up with this guy. All right, I will be the WWE champion. Maybe next time. All right, I wish you'd just let me close it manually. Stupid thing. I always gotta go for the update. This doesn't make any sense. Perhaps maybe I could actually just look through it the old-fashioned way. The drawer. Might have some stuff in
Winston,
here.
It's sure. Now or never. We gotta activate the robot! Come on now!
Yes. What is love, Master?
Maybe it's in this drawer. It's never in the second place you look.
Oh, fine. Just ignore me. I'll find love over here.
Oh, do I hear evil laughing?
I told you for the last time. I gotta find my lover. I just need to find him.
That's
you know where
here,
he
ma'am.
Is. I need to find him. Oh.
It's not safe to go inside, ma'am.
What do you mean it's not safe?
Now don't you argue with me. You're supposed to be the damsel in distress in the third act. Oh,
fine,
no,
fine, I'll
no,
just milk
ma'am.
Every scene I'm in.
Well, might as well give up after two locations. Oh no!
Robot
Whoa,
man.
I did not see this coming! Whoa, I just went into
Prepare
a random mansion.
To be exterminated.
I didn't know this day was gonna get this exciting.
I just realized bullets can't destroy me. Prepare for unwanted cuddling.
Oh jeez! Oh boy!
Come here,
oh,
big boy!
Geez.
I'm gonna show you
no,
how I love. Nice try. I am made of metal. Please don't.
Ooh, I wonder if this is going to impress Shania Twain. Because that does impress me much. Haha, yes. All right, let's
figure out
exactly
what's
going on
in here. Don't forget
about me, I'm
in this movie too.
I just realized the door's open. And the robot's still in the room and people are coming in. Oh, come on, robot. It's time to get going. Time to leave.
No, no. I gotta get out of here. Must cover up the murder. Oh, don't have enough time to bury body. All right, I'm coming. Please, don't be mad.
I think I hear a robot.
I just wanted love.
Aha! I did.
You did what? Oh, no! Get out of the way. Harold, are you alive? Harold? No, he's dead.
I have entered. Please pay attention to me.
A wise guy, huh? You dare not listen to your chieftain?
I'm terribly sorry. I have to concentrate on this thing. What can I do for you?
Really?
Sir, that's not a Fanta.
You wouldn't have it here if you didn't want people to touch it.
I know, but we're working with very volatile equipment here. That stuff is very dangerous.
Well, you know, curiosity killed the cat, but a satisfaction brought it back.
That's a good one, sir. But when someone's doing science crap, you just can't put your hands in the crap.
Oh, well, fine then. I'll go listen to Hoopastink or whatever.
Well, there's no need. Here, let me show you something really cool. You'll be like, whoa, that's crazy.
Oh, geez, Doc, you really know how to make science fun.
All right, you're going to be really impressed with this. I'm talking without moving my mouth. It's great. It's wonderful.
Why don't you just get on with it already?
Kablam!
Whoa, that's crazy. Oh, whoa, that's great.
You see, with the right chemical reactions, you can have all sorts of great puffs of smoke and whatnot.
Wow. My dream of becoming a magician has come true.
Oh, run, run, run. Oh, run,
hurry,
run,
they're catching
run.
Up. We have to get out of here.
Of here. Oh,
is there a problem?
Maybe if we go this way. Yeah. Oh, great, that's right. There's a boulder here. We can move it.
Oh, my God. We gotta get out of here. Oh, come
you
on,
need
guys.
To calm down over there, okay? I told the government as soon as they opened up the doors to the stores, we'll be in a whole heap of mess.
Get out of here. Oh god, look, they're coming! Oh my god,
there's gotta be a faster way!
Oh, jeez. At this point, this is the only worry.
Alright, we're getting it! Bush!
Push! The paper. Non-essential items
oh
for cleaning.
Ooh. They're right there!
We can clearly hear them.
Can I turn this item with our receiver?
One big push now. We got the fear in us.
Power of love!
Oh, jeez. I thought it would be easier when they open up the stores, but it just got a lot worse.
What do you expect? Customers are the absolute worst human beings of all time.
If you can consider them human beings in the first place.
Oh!
All right. That's enough. Those customers are the things that pay your guys' salaries, so you guys better be nice
whatever.
To them.
Whatever.
The customer's always right, damn it. Now I'm going to go scout ahead. I'm going to go call the offices and make sure they got plenty of toilet paper for next time.
Well, you know, the means of production haven't really stopped, so it kind of seems kind of pointless to buy out the stores.
Yeah, you would think, right?
Where'd you take me?
Quiet.
I have no idea where I am. I can't even see with this black
thing. Welcome to your new home. I hope you enjoy your stay as much as I like it here. It's a pretty nice house.
And who is that?
Why, it's, not sure, but this is my maid, and she's here to serve you in any form and capacity.
I can't help but notice your mole on your face.
Why, yes, she does have a mole on her face. Perhaps you can be a little less shrewd and judgmental and show her to her room? Don't mind her.
I'm awfully sorry. I didn't mean to be rude or anything. It's just the first thing I noticed on your face.
Can we just get on with it? I'm sick and tired of hearing about my beauty mark on my face. At least there's a roof over my head. That's all that really matters, I suppose. And look, what is this thing?
Well, that happens to be a potted plant, my dear. I'm growing an orchid up in there. Or orchid? Orchid? Whatever it's called, it's going to be an amazing plant. And I'm going to win competitions with it, too.
Let's go look at this place, I suppose. What? A picture of another woman on the wall? That happened to be Miss Strangler. She was Mr. Strangler's former wife. My God, this frame's amazing. Mr. Strangler happened to pick it up from the TJ Maxx. Sometimes I like to go in there just to yell at the retail workers.
Whoa, hey guys, wait up. Fine, I'll just take off my coat.
Will your new wife be joining us for dinner?
Well, does our accents keep changing?
I suppose, if you're really paying attention and rewatch this video. Pretty, pretty, pretty. I like being pretty. Oh!
Excuse me, you're interrupting us talking behind your back.
There's a snake right there!
Well, your fear is delightful to me. Very comical indeed. It's the snake's not poisonous. It won't stab you in the back. It doesn't judge you. It doesn't smile. Doesn't really laugh.
Cause you ain't funny.
It's just a harmless little snake. Perhaps it's more scared of you than you are of it.
I bet you have a whole explanation of why we even cut to this particular spot in the movie.
Well, the previous scene was over, so we decided just to jump on ahead to my lab, and I have all these beakers and—
Can you not make light of the situation? If you're gonna get people to watch this movie, it has to make sense.
I say a hip hop, a hippie to the hip hip hop. You don't stop the rockin' to the bang bang boogie, so what shape the boogie? To the boogie, to the boogie. Can't think of the rest of the words.
Do you think this is some kind of joke? Actually, the next part is what you hear is not a test, and I have forgotten the rest of the song.
Much like rap, it's really hard to come up with the lyrics to match the flow. Mm-hmm. But a lot of freestyling rappers, like myself and perhaps you, can always rely on a crutch. Now, everybody has a rap crutch that allows them to say things like, I'm Reginald Strangler, and I be strangling these rhymes from up top, down low, don't believe me, then I'll show. Stuff like that always works for me. You see where I'm coming from? Does that make any sense to you? Because sometimes you gotta write things down to make it flow.
Wow, I'm really jealous of your flow. Perhaps you can show me a little bit more about this flow you're talking about, and maybe my rap skills can improve.
Well, perhaps... You know, I've been kind of coming up with a formula that helps people rap. Would you be interested?
Don't do it! Don't do it! Don't do it! Don't be a rap god.
Boop-a-doop-a-doo, boop-a-doop-a-doo. Tubes? Circles? This is crazy. Excuse me, will you explain why all these tubes and beakers and stuff is all around in here, sir? Wait a minute. You're not a sir.
Well, for all you normal people, I identify myself as a female.
So what do you got cooking? Not that assuming that all females cook or whatever, but, you know, you're working with plants and I can see steam coming out from the plants.
You know, you could relax. I'm only cooking science stuff.
Science stuff? That's my favorite kind of stuff.
Well, if you're that interested in my science stuff, perhaps you would be interested in learning about my herbs.
So would you say that these are self-smoking?
Smoke? More like self-vaping.
Could you please elaborate a little bit more?
Alright, fine. You can't have fire in space.
Oh, so you don't have to light it up yourself.
Do you mind?
Well, vaping is the future, after all. You know, like all this vaping that's in the air, it's such a great opportunity to get the most impact from your herbs in the first place. Oh, wow. There's all kind of chemicals science, around in this
science,
place.
Science, 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 science. I like science. Well, could you stop science-splaining me? I'm the one with all the beakers and stuff. I think I know a little bit more about mixing and matching all sorts of these herbs than you do, handsome.
Oh no, I mean no disrespect to you. You are a scientist, after all. I'm just a guy who flies ships and hooks up things and does construction work in space. Your job is extremely important, and I respect you, not because you're a woman.
'Cause I'm hot to trot?
Yeah, sure.
Go on.
Well, it's just that I don't see many people in this profession who are in space and also do science stuff in space. I was in the military.
Thank you for your service.
Oh no, I'm not using that to pick you up. I'm just saying that I was in the service.
I wouldn't mind if you're using that to pick me up.
Yes, yes! Well, so you like watching movies and stuff? Maybe we could,
Well, my job keeps me very busy. When you're developing a self-smoking herb like me...
Oh no, you don't have to say it. I can take rejection. I'll just stand back here and idolize your work.
By work, I hope you don't mean my personality. Well, you know, I was thinking about taking a break from all this work. Perhaps you can join me later.
Yes, yes, please.
Perhaps a nice game of Uno would be a nice way to unwind.
Uno's the worst.
Game's at 8 p.m. sharp.
You can't relax and play Uno. It's just... It's just not how the game works.
I've been asking you this question over and over again. I expect a different answer.
For the last time, man, I don't know anything about nothing.
Well, we had you at the scene of the crime, and you were clearly intoxicated.
Ugh, man, so what if I had a couple drinks here and there?
It's not illegal to drink, but what you did is...
It's an unjust law, man.
Huh, I'm sorry, are you a police officer? I didn't think so. I'm a police officer. You're not na-na-na-na.
All right, it was dark. It was really dark. I couldn't see it.
The streets were illuminated after all, sir.
You can't expect me to look down all the time, and besides, it's a stupid superstition.
So you admit it?
Okay, so what if I did step on a crack? It's not like my mother's...
Your mother was admitted to a hospital because of her broken back!
It's a lie, man!
Alright, let's cool our jets, guys. This perp just admitted to stepping on a crack. We got him dead to rights.
Do you know the penalty for your actions?
You can't prove that stepping on a crack breaks your mother's back, that's stupid!
And yet here we are! After all, you're here, and your poor mother's in the hospital. Do you take any responsibilities for your actions?
Well, my...
That's what I thought. After all, some people don't like their mothers.
I like my mama.
What we see right here is your file, and on your file, it turns out that, you stepped on a crack more than once after all.
Come on, man. The streets aren't even lit that well.
And yet, you managed to step on every single crack. Why? Why do you hate your mama so much? What did she ever do to you?
His mama probably didn't want him to go to liberal arts college.
That's not the case, after all. I wanted to go to an Ivy League school. You can understand that, right?
Well, I might be a simple, detective around these parts. But I don't know anything about no Ivy League college.
Of course you don't.
But I do know that you broke the law.
Yep.
And around these parts.
Yeah, I get it.
It's funny that he gets it. Why is it that most people get it after they commit the crime in the first place? Alright. Let's send this guy over to the pen. He knows what he did. Just looking at his face makes me sick.
This is cold, man. This is cold!
I don't think so. Do you think we should throw away the key? He is a mommy backcracker after all. You know what they do to people like you in prison? You see what I did in there? I totally intimidated him. Really cool, man. Really cool.
Elevator. Huh? Am I on the right floor?
Oh, hey, it's a pretty lady. Do you want to come in?
Yes, but I can't stay long.
You might have noticed I put carpet on the ground so you don't need to have no sound effects for heels. You look like you could use a kombucha.
Oh no, don't trouble yourself.
Oh no, I insist, honey. You ain't one of those goop ladies, are ya? You know, those health kind of ladies who put health stuff inside health things?
A cigarette.
Well, I was gonna quit, but...
You smoke when you drink, I get it, honey.
Well, the funny thing is that I drink all the time. Here, let me help ya.
Oh, thank you.
Anything else?
I don't think so. Does the cigarette have eucalyptus in it?
No, it's only gonna kill you.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Give or take 30 to 40. Maybe a scientist will come up with smoking that's good for you.
Anything good for you is not addictive at
all. What about the runner's high? Don't laugh at me, I'm trying to be sincere. What I have right here is a health plan. You're gonna need this if you want to live to be 100 years old. You look like you got good genes. But we live in a man's world, which means you can't wear jeans.
Well, that's just mean. And unfair.
Well, what can I say? I'm a doctor. There's more to life than essential oils. You gotta treat your body like a temple.
Whatever.
And I don't mean the Temple of Doom, the worst of the Indiana Jones movies. Now drink your kombucha.
Chica-chica! I got a gun, yeah, and I'm gonna shoot.
Well, then, I guess I'll just hand over your health plan. You do know your gun's not cocked. I can attack you.
Thanks for the advice, honey. After I take this meal plan, I'll be invincible.
Was my misogyny?
So I, like, totally robbed that guy.
That seemed like quite the story, Miss Anderson. Let me ask you this simple question.
Oh, please, could you make it complicated for me?
All right, one train leaves Houston.
Not that complicated.
Well then, why'd you do it?
I told you, I need a healthcare plan.
Why is that?
Healthcare is so expensive.
Well, I don't blame you for your actions. But I don't like the way you acted on those actions.
One cannot survive on essential oils.
But you tried your best after all. I'm really glad you came to me. I'm here for you. Don't you understand? Maybe you should get a lawyer. And maybe a health guru. To help with all your sorts of health problems and whatever. So, what do you think?
You've got to be kidding me. I asked for help and you're not helping me. Why aren't you helping me?
Well, you robbed a doctor at gunpoint. Man, don't you understand this? You can't just go around stealing people's guns inside their homes and...
That's all circumstantial and semantics. And besides, what are my options in this endeavor?
Well, clearly jail time.
There is absolutely no way I'm going to jail on this. I don't like the sound of that sound. Besides, is there anything you can do to help me in this case? Just as I thought. You're no help to anyone.
Well, that's begone. You have a sharp tongue for someone who asks a lot of questions.
I only ask a lot of questions because I expect a lot of answers.
Oh, fine. I'm gonna help you, but it's not gonna be cheap.
I have a coupon.
That's not how coupons work, honey.
Well, if I'm paying full price, I expect you full treatment.
I guess I can do that. Hey, you want to hear a joke?
Oh, please, just stop.
Whatever.
Excuse me.
Why now?
I don't want to be waiting in the car. It's really boring.
Okay, I guess.
Stay fancy. Oh, come right into
offices.
Enough
with the pleasantries.
Oh, hi.
You're here to talk to that lady.
What you must remember is that you must be polite and kind to this lady, otherwise she'll faint for the millionth time.
And then we'll have nothing, I suppose.
Terrific Rooney. Welcome to this fancy mansion in this fancy hallway, where you can also play checkers, chess, AC-DC, all sorts of wonderful
things. I don't think so.
Ma'am!
I'm not ready. Hold on a second. I'm ready.
The officers you requested are here.
My name is Agent Callahan, and this is my partner, Jeeves. One must not confuse his name with a butler.
Why are you here? I didn't do anything wrong, did I?
Ma'am, I hate to inform you, but you are a person of interest in this case.
We appreciate you letting us in, but we're gonna have to ask you some hard questions.
My head. I have a headache of some sort.
I guess I'll help you lie down or whatever.
Partner, don't you think she's faking it?
Oh, wow. I feel so much better now. Thank you.
You need some water?
What is water?
I'll pretend you didn't say that. After all, you've been through a lot.
Oh, it is quite exhausting to go from one end of the mansion to the other.
Well, ma'am, I got a couple questions.
Oh, only a couple? Well, actually, to be perfectly frank, to answer any of your upcoming questions, I'm actually a size 2.
Huh?
Even though I lie and say I'm a size 0.
Hold on, I gotta write this thing down. Wait, where am I? Oh man, if only I had a book to write on. Too bad these books aren't for looking at.
Well, when I was a little girl, I used to go to the pond and see all sorts of snakes and frogs and... Hey, are you even listening to me? Oh, don't worry about them books. They're just for decoration.
Well, they seem to be out of order, ma'am. Do you want us to rearrange them for you?
Oh man, if only I can find a lighter.
Excuse me, sir. I'd prefer you don't smoke inside my mansion. I know there's a lot of air and everything, but please don't.
Well, next thing you're gonna say, it's bad for me.
Well, what I don't need is that secondhand
sadness. Don't worry, I got you.
Put on that couch.
I was totally expecting that.
All right, like I'll get a book to elevator feet. I got one book to elevator feet.
I don't mean to faint in front of gentlemen callers, but I did go to drama camp.
All right, enough screwing around.
Oh, you probably want to know where the gold's at.
You got gold?
That's why every man comes by here to get the gold.
Where's the gold?
The gold can be found at the end of the infinity pool.
Well, how do you expect us to get to the end of the infinity pool? It's infinity.
We just have to go infinity plus one.
No, that's scientifically impossible.
Don't tell me the odds.
I believe you can get to the gold because someone had to put the gold there in the first place.
This isn't like the end of Indiana Jones, right?
The gold's real.
Well, I'm going to go get a head start on the gold.
You wait right here, ma'am. Come on, let's get going, Jeeves.
Oof, no one has ever gotten to the end of the infinity pool.
There you are, kitty cat, kitty, kitty, kitty cat, kitty cat, kitty cat, kitty
cat. Jimmy!
Why'd I tell you my name?
You have to come out with me, please!
What? Like outside and whatever?
This one really pretty girl and her sister.
I'm assuming you get the pretty girl, and I get the sister.
Well, the pretty girl won't say, well, she won't go out with me unless we both go out together.
I'll do it.
Oh, thanks, Jimmy. I really appreciate it.
Well, maybe if I get the pretty girl and you get the sister, I will agree to that. On second thought, no. I can't.
What if I buy the drinks? You won't have to pay for anything.
Can we order dessert?
Just the New York cheesecake.
Hmm.
I don't want him to think that I'm hoity-toity or anything.
Agree to disagree.
Oh, well, if dinner goes well, maybe we can go ice cream afterwards.
I suppose. Let me just take this eyeliner off my eyes. I did just go to a Green Day concert, after all. One could not have too much guyliner, after all.
Oh boy, this is great. Okay, so you're gonna get all dressed up. Make sure you put on a nice coat. Clean yourself up just a little bit.
Do not fear. The girl that's meant for us will choose us in the end.
What do you mean by that? I don't understand what you're talking about.
Oh, it's quite simple, Hank. You be nice to a girl, and then you make her make all the decisions for you. And you don't have to do anything. You just expect it. You expect good things to happen to you if you're nice to women. So just be a nice guy. You can do that, can't you? Very good. Come on, let's go.
Oh, I think you're gonna need another coat, because back here in the 30s, there's no such thing as global warming, so therefore it's a lot colder. Maybe now we can change the future.
All right, let's not get carried away. We'll let the next generation handle it. We have more things to worry about back here, back in this era.
Like what?
Like, you know, disease and stuff. Listen, we can't change the world, but we can change tonight. For we will go out and we will have...
What are we gonna have?
You will see.
Come on, you can tell me.
It's a surprise.
Come on.
Come on, stop it. Come on, everyone. They can't shoot us all. I forgot what I was going to say.
Sorry, my dear, but the
We're in the middle of a staff meeting right now.
This is very important. You have to listen to us.
Hold on. Let me get my coat.
Oh, I remembered. Are you going to do anything about the sharks?
We're doing all we can.
I didn't know there were sharks here in this place.
There are no sharks here. We are landlocked. And besides, most of our rivers...
I am not done talking! You have to do something!
Whoopsie-daisy!
Have we had enough of this? I am sick and I'm tired of all this stuff.
We have a lot more problems than sharks around here. Whoa, whoa, watch out.
You see? Regardless of landlocked, the sharks can get us from anywhere.
Makes sense to me, yeah.
What are you gonna do?
Now listen here, we have to do something. And we gotta do it fast, because otherwise, the sharks are gonna get us all. Oh, what about Billy here? Juan can't just build more tables to stand on. We have to figure out how to get rid of these sharks before it's too late. Well, I'm open to suggestions. What do you guys think? A town is only as strong as a village. And we have Billy over here who's seen Shark Week, so maybe he can enlighten us a little bit more about these shark infestations.
So, what do you think, Billy? What do you think we should do?
Jeff, you start.
Hello, everyone. My name's Jeff, and...
What are you gonna do about these kids? They're throwing rocks all over at these people's windows.
And what are you gonna do about job security?
And how come no one went to my dog's recital?
What about the power of the press? We need more newspapers.
And who's gonna spread it? The backs of the workers?
My grandkids never come to visit me.
I need new kinds of hats and shops.
Yeah, come on, you need to do something.
New fashion line, new
designs. We can put fashion in newspapers.
All right, you guys stop complaining. We have to solve one problem at a time. We'll start out with the sharks, and then we'll work our way to maybe some hats, because, you know, everyone could use a new hat and everything. And besides, there's only a few of us, but tons of little shark things come flying around, becoming butchers, bakers, and candlestick makers, and you are just letting it all happen. It's all your fault. You can't expect us to solve your guys' individual problems. Get on out of here. I don't need this.
Do you think we'll celebrate Christmas? The dirty old Scrooge won't let my dad come home.
Oh, dear. I'm sure your dad's watching.
What do you think, Uncle Gary? Hello, Gary.
Yeah, I can hear you just fine now. Quiet.
Oh, please don't be cruel to the young boy. He has rickets.
To make sure that there is plenty of jobs out here to provide people some form of income, but money should be put aside so they could be insured. So if there's any workplace accident, their family's taken care of. Can you not do that? It makes sense, does it not?
Yeah, it makes sense, but I want my new hat.
And I think everyone should get a free hat with a signing bonus as well.
All right, see what I can do. Get out of here. God,
yeah, please.
Oh, demands. Now, don't you give me that look. I'm your king, or whatever. Well, that could have gone better, but it didn't.
Well, what do you suggest we do, sire?
Well, we can solve the shark problem, but the whole workers' right thing is going to be a whole nother mess.
I heard the Tsar got overthrown by all this.
We are not the Tsar. We are of the people, by the people, and the people made me in charge. And you are my viceroy. And you are going to make sure...
Oh, no worries. I'm going to make sure that you're going to be king for as long as possible.
Well, at least we're going to eat like kings.
Man. Why are you quiet, you? I'm trying to figure things out for the people.
Now, if I were everyone else, how would I solve the problem? Well, maybe I just, get a...
I'm over here.
The heck's going on?
And a little bit more to the left. Huzzah!
What? How did you get in here?
I can solve your shark problem. No problem. I solve all sorts of problems. I, after all, have a Van Dyke on my face.
His tunic keeps riding up.
Oh, my tunic may be short, but I am long in the heart, for I am here to solve your shark. I know that doesn't rhyme, but I am a good wordsmith. And besides, what do you have to lose?
A lot.
Well, I see that you do not trust what I'm trying to say, so I'm going to make this as simple as possible for you. By focusing on a singular problem, you will get the focus off of all other problems.
And how do you go about doing that?
Oh, I'm so glad you asked.
Alright, you listen here. How can solving one problem can solve all the problems for me?
You vilify the sharks.
Well, sharks are mindless creatures. How do you go about doing that with those creatures?
Perhaps we tell the people that they are the root of all evil and they have been causing all of their problems.
That's why we can't have good hats?
What are you going on about?
Oh, I think what he means is that all our problems can be rooted to the sharks.
Oh, one could even say that they prefer to eat people who don't work. Perhaps then people will get more jobs and put money into the economy. I'm so lesser to more intelligent people.
I think he's trying to say something. What is he trying to say to us? Well, you don't have to be intelligent to know exactly that you're in it for yourself, and you want something out of this, don't you?
Your silence is deafening.
I got the chicken, I'm gonna dance with the chicken, yeah. Rotisserie chicken, rotisserie chicken. You gotta turn it, you gotta turn it, yeah. You gotta turn it, you gotta turn it, yeah. You gotta turn it, you gotta turn it. Rotisserie chick, I like to put it on my face and yell. Look at the time.
Let's all hear it for Frankie the Frank. Well, good thing you didn't order the fish or anything, because I don't have any words that rhyme with fish.
And now we're going to play some heavy metal. Well, don't you just love this place? They're very inclusive when it comes to all sorts of...
You butchered my chicken!
Actually, honey, it was the butcher that butchered your chicken. I was not expecting you that kind of performance out of you.
I was channeling my inner Sammy Davis Jr.
That was the bee's knees, and we'd agree that Sammy would be proud.
Just see how I perform after hours.
We definitely got the cheeky part down.
I could really use a pickle.
Larry, get this man a pickle. Make sure it's nice and fancy like a dill.
I'm not getting this jerk a pickle. He's gonna need a bib.
You pay no mind to Larry.
Well, I'm good with kimchi, too. I just want something that's all vinegary and stuff that's been put inside a jar, if you can do that.
Excuse me, I saw that you had pickled eggs. Could you get some for us?
I don't want pickled eggs. I'm not eating with you.
Well, calm down, babe. Me be cool.
Well, pay no mind to him. He doesn't know what he's thinking. You're gonna sit down and have a pickled egg. You got it? Now you go sit down.
Oh, babe, why don't you calm down? It's,
you're quite a strong lady.
Waiter, I want the chick. I can't stand sitting next to these people.
Well, I'm happy to go a la carte with you folks. I got a tab in this bar.
All right, let's see what the damage is.
What is this thing?
Oh, what did you buy?
Excuse me, I aged like a million years from this chick.
Oh, yeah. You didn't know you had to pay for water?
The day I pay for water from the toilet is the day I'm leaving. I'm getting on out of here. I don't need this crap.
What? Well, not leaving.
Well, whatever. I can get the money back from the ring.
You!
No, let's calm down there, guys.
You think you can leave me on top? I'm leaving you! Boom!
If I wasn't so scared of you, I wouldn't be so scared of you. Now look at this badge. I'm out of here.
I'm assuming your wedding's going to be in San Diego.
Woohoo! Ooh!
Hey, Beth, I'm sure you made the right decision.
I'm assuming lead singers and bands make lots and lots of money. Why are you laughing? Well, how much do you make?
Boys, here's your MTV.
Oh man, MTV again! I hate MTV. What about VH1?
What? That's not VH1 anymore.
I think that's Paramount now.
There you go.
Oh man, the parties keep getting bigger and bigger. I tell you what.
Oh man. Big one. Go on now. Eat it.
Oh. Wow, this is some good pie looking thing here. I love this kind of pie. I can't wait to have this pie in my mouth, and it's going to be delicious. Heck yeah. Ooh, hoo-wee! This pie is so delicious. Nom nom nom.
I can't believe you have pie like this every day.
No, not every day. It's just some days. Hey guys, let me talk more about my mouthful.
Nom nom. Eat. Munch, munch, munch. Nom 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 nom.
Oh, hey guys, let me check out this jewelry box
jewelry,
that's in the middle of the dining
table. I can buy
myself
the surgery one.
So, Bugsy, what do you think about the food?
Yeah, they're pretty good.
Boy, howdy.
Hey, man, this is the life. I like these kind of cigars. Perfect time to talk business. What do you guys think about talking business? It's good. It's not business that good, is concluded. Man. Any new business you guys want to talk about, or just want to talk about old business, as in business being good? I got something to say.
Quiet. Well, why do you gotta come down like that?
He listens to alternative rock.
Oh, that isn't so bad.
You know what goes good with a cigar? A nice crust dissolve.
Oh, maybe the crust is.
Maybe some
much.
People with asthma shouldn't smoke. Nah. This isn't organic.
Cigars don't compliment pies at all, I tell you what.
I just wanted to listen to Hoopa Stank.
Oh, you guys quit coughing, you're bumming me out. Alright, maybe this crust dissolve will help you guys feel better about smoking those cigars, but I don't know. I'm just a guy.
I can't believe you made us smoke those cigars.
I pace myself, so I'm the last survivor.
I don't want to be a tough guy anymore.
Oh, come on, scatter!
What seems to be going on in here?
Why don't you go tell him, Smokey?
Well, good thing smoking is the worst thing they can do.
Oh, but I'm distracted by the feet on the table.
Perhaps smoking cigars is the reason why feet are on the table.
Well, you're not wrong, after all. I do don't like smoking.
Couldn't have said it better myself. Yeah! Come on, let's get going. We got dates.
Oh, with who?
Yeah, you'll see.
All right, we're here, honey.
I just gotta get away from you. Don't worry about this sign.
What do you think you're doing over there?
Oh, don't worry. If we take care of this sign, we don't have to be worried about being arrested.
You sure about that?
Don't worry. Just a minor chemical spill. Come on, we're gonna have a picnic. It's gonna be fun. We might go swimming. Come on now.
All right, let me put on the parking brew.
Please stop.
No.
It's like I'm in a police academy movie. Ugh. All right, now get your butt out of here. We're gonna have a picnic and it's gonna be fun.
All right, I'm coming. But if I get cholera, it's all your fault.
You're just silly. Just walk it off. It's no big deal.
Oh, this is heavy. Did you remember to bring sandwiches?
I put the sandwiches right there.
That's weird. I remember the weight distribution of plates, blankets, but I don't
I'm sure I put it in there.
If it isn't in there, I'm calling the police.
Oh, on lack of sandwiches? I don't think so, silly.
You forgot the sandwiches. I knew you'd forget the sandwiches.
Well, did you make sure to bring the Wednesday picnic basket? No.
You have picnic baskets for different days?
Well, a daily picnic basket is for a small meal, but if you take it on the week, you need a big meal. What do you think about that? You're being silly.
Well, I guess I'm the stupid one, and you're the smart one.
Well, you do pack your favorite Lunchables every day before you go to work. And besides, you should have known better to pack those sandwiches in the...
I don't like it when we fight. Could you ever forgive me for my transgressions?
Honey, don't worry. I've got you. Now, sit here. Oh, you see? The sandwiches were inside you the whole time.
Oh, gee, thanks. You see all where the light touches the lake? That's all ours.
But what about that shadowy place?
Karen, you must never go there.
Oh, but now I definitely want to go. How come you tell me that there are these wonderful places that I just can't go? It's just not fair. I'm just a wannabe emo girl.
Let me tell you something about that dark place. That dark place is evil. It's a place where people go and they don't come back from. You can't go there. Please promise me you will never go there.
Oh, I definitely want to go now.
I know you really want to go. But you have to trust me. This is very dangerous. If you go, you may never come back. Do you understand?
I understand.
Listen, I'm not doing this so you can't sow your oats. I want you to sow your oats all over the place. Just not in the shadowy place. Do you understand?
Mm-hmm. It's just so hard for me to take directions from a man.
This episode of Dubbin Stuff was recorded in front of a pre-recorded audience.
Ooh, and that guy in the audience goes, ooh.
Oh, man.
That was quite the party last night.
Doug, Doug, you better get up. You're going to be late for work.
Oh no, I can't lose this promotion. Wait, why do I keep hearing strange laughter? Shut up!
Oh, and I laid down your underwear. Don't forget to wear your underwear!
Oh, man. When is this madness going to end? Oh, where did I put my toothbrush? Oh.
Whoa, get okay. That toothbrush.
All right, this laughter's getting kind of weird. Oh.
Doug.
What?
I'm sorry,
it's
I
wet?
Used your toothbrush.
That's hilarious.
Will you just be quiet? I'm coming. Using my toothbrush. I'll use your toothbrush. What?
Doug, you shouldn't be snooping in my special room. It's not for you. I told you like a million times.
Yeah, I know. I just need to get in there for something.
Oh?
Yeah, somebody used my toothbrush, and I wanted to see if you had an extra toothbrush in there.
Oh, well, you know, Doug, you shouldn't be asking other people to use their toothbrush. It's just, you know, it's very...
I can't hear you. I can't understand you.
I'm your sister. You should be able to hear and understand what I'm saying. Can't you hear the words that are coming out of my mouth?
I think I understand that reality is crashing in on itself. That we live in this world that doesn't exist anymore.
Oh, how can you say that? You're my brother. This is reality. But besides... I'm just really worried about you, okay? This is real. Real to me.
Well, it's not real at all. We're in a show where people dub over our voices.
It should be good enough for you. Reality's what you make of it. And if you don't like that,
you don't have to be here anymore.
Hello? Excuse me.
You've been excused.
Father.
No? Johnny, is that you?
I'm sorry to barge in like this, Father, but I'm in need. I'm hungry.
Oh, you meet me at a good time. I'm going to get a pizza.
Pizza sounds really good. I want a pizza.
Oh, and you expect me to pay for it, don't you?
I'll pay you back.
Oh, you're in college, don't you know?
I'm good for it. I'll just have my parents wire me the money.
And the money that you had? What did you do with the money that your parents already gave you?
I spent it on Whole Foods. I only went there once, but all my money's now gone because of it.
You're a healthy boy, aren't you?
It was my turn to cook.
Oh, I see. Oh, the Irish greens. Oh, the devil's lettuce, I say. Perhaps, maybe, you should be a little more frugal with your money after all. Oh, I guess I could. Oh, pay for the pizza this time. But know this, Johnny. Not everyone can shop at Whole Foods.
Thank you, Father. I really appreciate this. I'll never forget it. I'll make sure you have the best pizza around next time I come in here.
Well, the best pizza is only measured in how much pineapple it is on that pizza. Perhaps a pure pineapple pizza would be in order. Wouldn't you say... Pineapple is the blood of this church, after all. Of course, I could be tempted to add maybe pepperoni to that pizza and some extra cheese. Yeah, the cheese sounds nice. Is there something on your mind? No, it's just... I don't like pineapple on pizza. Nobody does.
Oh, don't get carried away now, don't you know? Well, fine, can we get half and half?
Oh, not that I'm being so generous. You think you get to choose what you want on the pizza?
That's just sinful.
Well, not everyone likes pineapple on pizza, don't you know?
Oh, I'm a small group of people who like pineapple.
Well, it must be the same Catholic priest who done... never mind. Forget about it. You're kind enough to order the pizza. I should be kind enough to eat it. No matter how many pineapples are on it.
Well, you know, there used to be a time when there were no pineapples around. Nobody knew what the taste of pineapple...
Wow, that sounds a lot like heaven to me. Maybe this pizza can be more traditional. Whoops. No, don't worry about it. It's just, my religion, after all. So, when were you thinking about ordering that pizza? I was wondering maybe that we can get another piece of pizza with it as well? I don't see why not. Oh, what do you want? Oh, you're writing this down? Great. Mm-hmm. Alright, I want meat lovers with a side of ranch, and maybe you can get some of the stuffed crust stuff that everyone likes has been raving about. If it's not too much trouble.
Oh, the Saints! No. That's not too much trouble.
Oh. I wish I could go out and pick it up myself. I would be willing to get it, pick it up, maybe, if you want to trust me with some money, and then maybe I can get some drinks as well.
Oh, well, perhaps drinks sounds like a good idea. We'll make sure they double-bag the drinks.
What do you think I am, an idiot? I can make sure they double-bag the drinks. And I'll get two really big jugs. I'm sorry, Father. I should have asked what kinds of drinks you wanted.
Make sure they're not name brand, and one of them is a pineapple soda.
What the hell's wrong with you? Are you crazy? You can't put pineapple on pizza and then drink pineapple.
Oh, come on now. First you judged me on my pizza, and now you're judging me on my soda drinks.
I just can't win with you. You just don't like anything.
That's not true. I don't like anything. I just don't like pineapple.
My money, my rules. If you don't like it, then you don't have to order it.
No normal human has as much pineapple as you. You're crazy.
Oh, you think I'm crazy, don't you? Well, I'm going to order the pizza. And I'm gonna make you get it for me. All pineapple on both pizzas, and you're going to like it.
Here I go. I'm going to pick up the phone. I'm going to order the pizza. Boop-a-doop-boop. Oh. Ooh. Mm-hmm. Mmm. Pizza. Hello, pizza guys. I want a pizza with extra pineapple. They know my number. They got caller ID. Here, I have the money for the pizza. Please. No, don't fret.
I don't want your damn pineapple.
Well, the pizza's not going to pick it up itself.
And I sure as hell's not gonna get it.
Oh, really? Perhaps maybe I'll go myself and go get the pizza.
At least look me in the eye when you're screwing me over. I don't need this pineapple pizza.
Pineapple is really good. I like pineapple. I must eat pineapple on all my foods. If I don't have pineapple,
oh
then
God.
What is the point of living?
Well, since you have no point in living, how about you take some of this? It was that day that I knew. That I had to finally get rid of the scourge that is pineapple. God forgive me for what I'm about to do.
I wonder what that was about. Oh, back to work.
Excuse me. I'm looking for a car mechanic.
Well, I believe you came to the right place.
I want to make this real quick. I need an oil change on a vehicle that does not have oil in it. Would that be possible for you to do an oil change?
Yeah, I guess I could.
Now don't yank my pantyhose. I want to know exactly how you're going to do it without oil.
Well, it's really quite simple. You put oil in and you take oil out. It's that simple.
As you may already know, this was a test and you've passed. Good job. I am very impressed by your customer service.
Oh, geez, don't tell me this is one of those undercover boss situations. I'm my
own
boss.
I've never seen that show.
Anyone with eyes have seen that show.
Well, I follow more on the lines of a critic than a undercover boss type. I'm writing an article about you.
Well, still, this wasn't unfair to ask me these kind of questions.
Well, don't you see? You're going to be in the newspapers.
Newspapers are a dying medium.
Well, we do have an online blog. Perhaps that would help you in your businesses in the future. The only people who read blogs are women between jobs and nothing better to do. Exposure is all you need for business. I think I expose myself plenty of times to plenty of people. Self-exposure seems very desperate. And in these times, you need help to expose yourself, you see? I could use help exposing myself. If I have your consent, I'll be publishing this in our monthly magazine.
Monthly?
And with this exposure, you'll get tens of hundreds of people to come to your auto shop. Does that sound good? I'll take your silence as a yes.
Time to... Oh, you really are an animal, aren't you?
Yes.
Well, I don't really like the looks of him. But maybe we should put him down.
Well, I don't know about that. Usually you gotta neuter him first.
I'm dying. Thank you. You know, I'd rather not be neutered.
Oh man, come on, we do this every single time.
Oh, what's that supposed to mean?
Well, you say you want a vasectomy, but then you, like, chicken out, but you always tell us that we have to make sure you
like
get the...
sounds like you're putting words in my mouth.
No, I'm just repeating what
well,
you said.
You should know better. You shouldn't listen to me. I say a lot of crazy stuff.
But this is, like, the ninth time you've asked us just to make sure you get a vasectomy.
Well, just because I say I want one, and then... chicken out, as you say, doesn't necessarily mean I'm ready for a vasectomy. I'm really trying here, and you're making this very difficult for me. It's just not fair.
You've sired so many kids.
I know. And then when their moms try to get alimony from me, I tell them no. And then they get really mad. But I think one of those mothers finally got me. They finally stabbed me in a very, very bad place. Charlie! Listen to me.
What is it, Frank?
I need you to liquidate my assets.
Okay, that's easy.
And hide them away from my children. Ugh.
I got a vasectomy years ago.
Gross.
Well, you know, some of his kids are pretty nice, you know. But most of them are just terrible. But, you know, they've kind of been poisoned by their mother, but
well,
for good reason.
This wasn't quite the day that I was expecting.
Huh. Want to grab fast food?
Intimidating enough? Well, is anyone gonna answer me? Oh, this guy again.
My liege, I'm here. I have prisoners and they.
That's
are...
enough. Bring them in. Let me see what we got this time.
Sir, you quite don't understand that he's very quite handsome.
Go, guard. Find out if you can use quite more than once in a sentence. And release the... I mean, bring out the prisoners. Whew, almost messed up there. Oh, God, he is gorgeous. Look at those pants. Welcome. I'm the ruler. This is a formality. Any outsider shall be arrested. It's nothing personal. It's just... I'm a leader, and I gotta lead by example. You understand that?
Oh,
I am the professor. I come from a place called Earth.
And I'm an alien dictator.
Oh, I've met many people in power before. They were quite interesting, but one thing's for sure. Their curiosity outranks their savagery.
Oh, I've been to the Earth. And when I was there, I was like, let's go. Only because I didn't get any mileage for my credit card.
Well, have you shopped around other credit cards? Speaking from experience of being bankrupt a handful of times.
Financial advice? You should not be giving me...
Well, just because I went bankrupt doesn't mean I don't know anything about money.
Well, maybe if I was showing signs of bankruptcy, I would take your advice. This is my accountant, Gene McDonald. He's really good at financial stuff.
I don't know why I bother.
Get out of the way. Get out of the way.
Oh, no.
Is she prettier than me?
It's my
wife.
She looks
prettier than me. Oh, but look at that.
All right, I'm getting up. This is what happens when you make me get up. It's not pretty. Hold her. Now, you see here, because you're a lady coming to my castle, you have to marry me. It's the law of the land, and I make the law. All your desires will be met. My credit score is 850. Whoa!
Now you listen here. You stay away from her. I don't want you to see her with her.
Nice Batman voice. Get him.
I hope you like face in your face.
Oh, wow. Is he trying to sound tough or is it just like Batman face? Oh, now he's got a sword. But come on, guys.
I got him.
Oh, yeah. There. Yeah. That's easy.
You know, sure, you're tough one-on-one, but I got a whole bunch of guards. What are you thinking? Still fine.
I guess we could go over here.
All right, guys, this is my moment. My moment to shine, and you have to listen to me. Things are going crazy out there. Things are pretty crazy.
Oh, dear God.
You were moving those glasses aren't as earnest as you thought they were. Now put them back on. Oh, man. All right, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to yell at you. I just want attention. And this is my moment to shine.
Okay.
Oh, man. Being the new sheriff in town is really difficult. I have to hold a gun.
All right, let's get you in here.
Well,
what's
going on?
Okay. All right, take a seat. You're going to be fine. You might be wondering what's going on with this guy. Now, let me tell you. He's a drunk. A sad, sad drunk.
Now, you listen here. You don't talk to him like that. He is a very... He comes from a bar. Doesn't make him a horrible person.
Okay. Don't get your pennies in a bunch. We're going to need him at the top of his game if we're going to survive this night. Besides, don't you have a gun? Aren't you going to defend us? This is a crazy night. Well, your silence says that you're probably not going to help us, but hey, you know, listen.
Listen, my moment to shine is going through that door, and I'm going to come out a hero.
That, my boy, is a window. Do you actually think that you can go through a window that easily?
Listen, it's not what you do, it's how you do it. Good, bad, drunk. There's so many different things about this place that you have to think about.
I'm not trying to make you angry or anything.
I need to get out of here. This place sucks.
Oh, jeez. You got cut. Now it's my time to shine. Gun! All right, I got you. Oh, no, I didn't. Gun again! Ha ha! No one can stand my stand. Gun? Are you okay? You look like you've been, scratched.
I'm gonna be okay.
I think you need to go to the hospital. Come on.
Oh, no, I'm fine. I'm just gonna write an editorial about this. Dear USA Today, I do not like these animals that just come into your houses, scratch your ankle, and just go, blah, 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 blah. Whoa.
Can't you see you're doing the shooting wrong? Here, you can't shoot him when you can't
really
see him.
Difficult to write.
Unless
you
can see through doors, you really can't shoot those things.
And that's when I decided to have a heart attack, and so people would pay more attention to me.
Oh, don't listen to him. He's just faking it.
Whoa!
Oh, wow, that's some good acting right there.
I think you really did have a heart
attack. Those monsters! Those monsters could kill us!
That's enough humming from you.
I'm trying to read in silence.
I'm just humming the song that we danced to at our wedding. You don't have to be so weird about this. I'm just trying to lighten the mood. You know you're going to have to talk to me. You can't just go back to your book and ignore this. This is a fight. What happened to us? We used to talk for hours about just absolutely nothing. And now you're just all obsessed with that book and laying down and relaxing.
I work hard to put bread on the table. The least you can do is leave me alone. Oh no, don't think you can win by giving me the silent treatment.
It's not really about winning. It's about understanding, which you don't understand what I'm going through.
Understand? What do I have to understand? You don't even work.
This relationship is work. I pander to all your needs.
My needs? What kind of needs do you need?
The least you can say is thank you.
You're right. I'm sorry.
A what?
I said I'm sorry, and thank you for everything that you do for me, like setting up this hammock and everything. And that dog, you take care of him very well. You see, he's growling at me.
Hello, I heard yelling and I had to check it out.
Margaret, I need you to be a third party to our discussion that we're having.
what's going on here?
Manfred was yelling at me for humming our favorite song, and when I challenged him, he just didn't explain why he wanted me to stop humming that song in the first place. It's like he says no to this, no to that. But does he ever say yes to anything? I don't think so. And now he's even laughing at me.
Oh, well, you just get all carried away now, don't you? I don't know why I got this accent all of a sudden, but I'm really sick and tired.
You're sick and tired? I've committed 4 years of my life to you. And what do I get in return? Old man sassafras.
False news. You married me. You're the one that asked me to marry you. And may I remind you, I'm the one with the job. So, what do you got to say about that?
Ruh-roh.
Yeah, that's right. Oh? I see it. I see how it is. You're both giving me the silent treatment. You think you look at me, I'm like I'm some kind of monster. Well, I'm not. I'm going to go back to my book. And when I'm done reading, that attitude better be done as well. I'll tell you what.
Cool. I'm so very cool.
Did you just sing "You're Cool"?
No.
It sure sounded like you did.
Well, wasn't really.
Perhaps you'll be coolish me later on. But I really doubt it.
Jeez. You know, I'm just trying to sing to myself. You know, you gotta entertain yourself. Ugh, what a jerk.
Alright, listen. If you want to be as cool as me, you gotta slur those S's. You gotta walk like me. You gotta talk like me.
Oh, boy.
All sorts of things like me.
All right, let's get this over with. Well, what are we trying to do? Doing some basic
just
maintenance?
Follow orders.
Great.
Beep, boop, boop, beep, boop, boop. Futuristic sounds, beep, boop.
Hello there. Welcome to DJ Knight's Moons.
Sir, this isn't a good time to start a podcast.
Well, then when is?
Okay, let's launch this thing.
Podcasts are pretty topical. I do a lot of top tens and a lot of how-tos and all sorts of pretty clickbaity type.
Okay, videos. Launch. Johnson? Ugh, don't tell me he's asleep again. Can somebody get Johnson? I need Johnson. Get Johnson right here. Hurry up.
We're on a bus.
Isn't it weird that we're walking
like
this?
Let's go find Johnson.
This is how people walk in space.
All right. Quit screwing around, you guys. We gotta find Johnson.
Whoa. I didn't know fire could be bluish white.
Are you guys ready to listen to my podcast? All right, so anyways, I was talking to some lady from Venus 12, and she was like, what? And I was like, whoa.
We spotted Johnson.
You said Johnson.
Oh, I get it now. It's only as funny as you make it.
You just got it?
Shut up. In space, we can lift him up easily. Oh, did you come up with that on your own? I can't wait to see the trailer.
Oh, did you know that trailers are actually having their own trailers? It's like a teaser before the trailer's shown?
What? That's stupid. Oh, you know how it is.
No, I don't know how it is. Why didn't you explain it to me?
Well, a long time ago, you know, just to put on hype for images of, like, you know, franchise-type movies, people are expecting a sequel to come up. They make a teaser for a trailer of an upcoming movie.
That's stupid. I hate it. They should just have, like, one trailer and then just let people have their expectations based on the trailer hyped up until they actually see the movie so they're not completely disappointed from being spoiled too hard.
Chicka, woo, 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 woo.
Hey, hey, hold up. Hey, hey, hold up, hold up. Come on, come on, stop. Please stop, please. Okay, okay, okay. Salute you.
That's ought to be good.
Welcome to my train station.
I want to know exactly why you stopped this train.
Are you happy with your mail service?
Well, yes, I am.
Well, what if I told you that there was a better way?
I'm going to have to swear. That's bull honky. And this is not the best way to get your mail.
Well, at least hear me out. This will revolutionize delivery.
Train is best. We are in the midst of a revolution, after all. What do you have that we can't provide?
Well, hear me out. These aerodynamic systems will cut down the use of these dusty old trains.
Are you saying my trainers are dusty?
Well, does a bear shit?
Now don't you get me started. Well, you see there, Sonny? I like trains. Wait a minute. I'm trying to sell you something.
Listen, we don't got any time.
Now listen, Pelicans.
We have to go.
We trained a whole bunch of pelicans. See, look at them fly.
Those are clearly pantyhose or pants.
Oh, well, our pelicans are grounded. Wait, are you trying to tell me that your revolutionary system is pelicans
delivering the mail? Well, yeah. Why not? Come on, just listen. These trains are not going to last forever. You need a more natural approach to deliver the mail.
Let's get the heck out of here.
No, let's not get the heck out of here.
Oh, I'm sorry, the train?
No, I'm not the train. All right, everyone. Let's haul out all the mail. Come on now.
Oh, come on. We don't have time for this.
Yes, I know about time, and you guys invented the whole, you know, time zone system.
Yes, train people did invent time, so listen
up. Now, you listen here. You want to save time?
Don't you dare poke me. I'm leaving. I don't need this.
I got one last idea. Give me your hat.
You can't just put on a hat and expect to trick me. I know
faces.
Well,
hey, listen, why do they call it male and not female?
I don't want to get into this with you.
You're just ignorant. I have half a mind to report you to Rockefeller himself.
You got one thing right. You do have half a mind. Mind.
Oh, jeez. We'll get the next train. I just know it. George. Hey, George, where are you?
I'm right here. Look what I got.
Don't tell me that you stole these.
I did not steal them.
Oh, okay. Well, wait a minute. No, you're in trouble now, Buster.
Hello? Anybody home? Hello? Oh. See, she hasn't redecorated in years.
I'm over here, honey. Come on in. Now, don't you judge my decorating scheme.
Hello?
Oh, long time no see. Look at you.
Yes, I'm quite beautiful. After all, there are no mirrors on the train.
Well, turn off the light and kiss me pretty. It's, you, this is...
Well, yes, it is a fur.
I'll report to DePita later, so let's sit down. I got a couple questions I just have to have answered. But first, we're gonna have some tea. Are you ready for my questions?
I'm kind of tired.
Tired? Tired from sitting on the train all day and...
Well, yes, a long day of not doing anything makes you even more tired and restless. I think I might just turn in.
Oh, well, you know... Whatever.
Well, once I've rested a few hours, I'll be more than happy.
No, I get it. I understand that you are having some lady problems.
Well, no more than other women. I'll tell you what.
Well, I'm just concerned you're not living up to your potential. I'm just saying that you should
don't you tell me how to live my life.
Well, I heard from Jessica that she can't have kids.
Well, we're not talking about Jessica.
Man, I pray if your mom was alive today, she'd be dying of shame.
God only knows.
Well, your mom was a terrible person. Well, I guess that's settled. We'll talk more about that later, but let me talk more about my grandkids.
And so, this movie, it's huge. it's these two women who are basically inside the room, and they're just talking back and forth.
Play your cards.
On and on and on and on and on and on.
What kind of cards do you got? Well, I'm not supposed to tell you what my cards are. That's not how the game works. We've been playing all night, staking forever, just to deal out and see who wins, see who lost all this money.
Okay, can I continue with my story? All right, so the two women, they find out that they have more in common than they think they originally did, which...
Now you listen here, you shut your mouth.
Okay, I'll stop.
Why does it sound like I've seen that movie before?
Well, no, it's not quite like a lot of the other movies. It's just... Listen, you're not really paying attention to the story.
It's just another... Ready, chop! Looks like I won. Yeah. You sure know how to play a card game you made up.
Yo, so I was wondering, what did you think?
I didn't really think much of it. It was really stupid and repetitive. You're just jealous because you didn't think of it yourself. Don't run that mouth of yours.
Well, I'm just saying is that usually people who are very critical are the most jealous.
Why you gotta go there? I'm just saying, you know, we're just playing a friendly game. This game ain't friendly. I'm just trying to pitch my idea to you guys.
Listen, this movie's gonna be big. A lot more women are gonna show up paying tickets to buy this thing. You see?
No one's gonna want to see that
movie.
Come on,
we just have to shop around let you a couple make it studios. Either.
You get out of here.
Pick it up?
No.
You listen here. Those are the most basic of the basic plot lines of any chick flick.
Okay. Have some more alcohol. Maybe you'll, maybe you'll be more inclined to listen. Drink responsibly.
Sorry to keep you waiting. I was hitting on younger ladies.
Oh, it's fine. I know how you are with little girls.
Well, let's ignore how much of a horrible person I am, and let's talk about some business. Hello, waiter.
Well, the reason I brought you here is I wanted to 80s-style close that...
That's impossible.
Breadstick stat.
Well, somebody's hangry. What's your deal? What's going on?
I just want my unlimited breadsticks, if that's okay with God, and...
What is it? What's going on?
Nothing.
I know you're dabbling in Scientology.
Well, not exactly Scientology.
More like exactly? You're starting to scare us.
What about all the things that I do every week? This is the one that scares you? I have so many secrets.
Well, first of all, no, I'm not going to give you any money for your whatever ascension program that you're in. We're not only scared, but we're really annoyed by you. You're always saying that the world's gonna end.
Well, it's gotta end sometime.
Well, I don't think it's gonna end in your lifetime. I think it's gonna end when the sun goes out.
Oh, well, that may be, my dear. But, that could happen tomorrow.
It could be happening right now. We could always live a little if you want to. We could, you know, live like we're dying. And maybe appreciate life a little bit more, if that's okay with you.
Oh, what would make you want to say that kind of stuff to me? Anyways.
Well, I want to get your hopes up, honey. This is my serious face, and I've got to be serious to you. We're not going to happen. You come around here with your 40-plus-year-old good looks, and you expect me to like you? It's not completely insane to not like you. In fact, you are kind of a beta male if you really think about it.
Is that what you think?
I do. And it's getting harder and harder to hide these feelings about you. Just so you know, having feelings for someone isn't always
impossible.
Good.
Okay, listen here. I'm,
stalling for time as you're sipping out of that cup. We've known each other for many years now. We've had good times. We've had bad. We've had all sorts of weird times trying to save Christmas for the umpteenth time. Come on, Santa. Get your stuff together. We can't just do it by ourselves. There comes a certain time in our lives where we must decide what path we need to take.
I just want to shut this ski lodge down and open a mega ski lodge for rich people.
And I support you 90% of the time, but this time, I can't just let those school kids go broke and just be on the streets. It's just not fair. It's not cool at all. Do you hear me? I gotta go. See
you
later.
Hold on a second. We haven't even eaten yet.
I'm not really that hungry.
Why don't you just relax? We'll talk more about this, and we can actually have a decent meal. So come on, hang out for a bit.
Can I order desserts?
As long as you run 3 miles afterwards.
We now turn to Superman selling stamps to children.
All right, for the last time, you need stamps to send letters, packages, and all sorts of things. Don't just stare at me. I'm a person. A very strong person, no doubt. But a person nonetheless. And I demand some kind of respect from you kids. Do you understand that?
I like Superman.
Yes, we know you love me. But let me make this clear. Is that I'm trying to get you guys to buy stamps and make it your civic duty. Who's gonna write to your grandma on her deathbed? I know for sure that I'm not going to write her. But if I had to, I would write your grandmother. She's a hard-working lady, and she's from one of the greatest generations of all time, from the 1920s. They survived an economic depression. I'm assuming people who were already poor, they didn't have to really worry about it as much as the people who had more to lose. In some ways, the more you lose, the less you are. So, does anyone kind of understand what's going on here? Because I'm kind of losing track. Okay, well, see you later.
Do you understand what he was talking about?
No, I don't understand. Wait, Superman!
Oh, we don't understand what you're saying! We're going to support the federal post office right
now.
Do it now.
Do it now. Robots,
we are compliant.
Also stamp by whatever you tell us to buy.
Another day, another shameless promotion. Hi, how you guys doing?
I'm Lois Lane, and I have a lot to say about a lot of different things. Now you guys better listen, because I got the scoop of a lifetime.
Did you cover Superman on Stamp Day? It was awesome! Superman was there, he was selling out.
Of course.
Of course he was! He's Superman! He's here to sell to you! Don't you understand that?
Oh, come on, back me up, Clark! Do you really think that Superman...
Well, in the newspaper business, a picture is worth 1,000 words.
Oh.
And what do you guys think about
thank
that?
You.
You got some primo stamps, courtesy.
Well, these stamps better not go to Superman's head, I tell you what.
Oh, they will, Lois, they will.
Grandma!
No, you don't love me!
Think of something smart or sexy, sassy to say.
Looks like the ceiling needs some repairs, honey.
That's quite true. After all, we do have a really run-down house with the salary that you bring in.
Aw, man, I sure know how to pick 'em. Beautiful and cruel.
I hate what you just said. I like the first part the most. But my beauty's gonna fade one day, and all you have is this cruelty of your own making. I'm not being melodramatic.
Did you just read my mind?
You're just being paranoid. I'm not the girl from Firestarter. I'm not Drew Barrymore.
Honey, I know you're not Drew Barrymore. I've come to accept that now. I would never trade up for anybody, especially all the bushels of Barrymores out there. It was as I looked into her eyes that I totally knew that she never loved me. How can one woman love a man who likes tiny hats?
You know, I've always accepted your tiny hat collection. But... it's not quite for me, after all.
It's just a hobby, you know?
Now? But what about later, when the sun goes down, and you go late in the workshop?
Listen, we're gonna make a fortune selling those tiny hats, you hear me? We're gonna make a fortune!
You've got to be kidding me. You're still trying to sell those tiny hats after all this?
It's not just tiny hats. You can put them on dogs, you can put them on babies.
I don't want to see any babies with those tiny hats on.
Okay. I will not put them on babies. I'll just leave them on
you
dogs, okay?
You just don't
okay?
get it. It's a slippery slope. First dogs, and then babies, and then what?
Shut up! Shut up! You're coming to me! I'm hurt. Call, please. Call someone. I'm dying.
Thank you.
Oh, Jeff, please, come in. How you doing?
Well, you know, it ain't easy being a detective in a sci-fi movie, but I'm a-trying. Best as I can.
For that boat you will buy, I will love you. For all the stuff that you buy me for today. Yes. I just wanted to say thank you for watching me sing about my privileged life. I'm rich. So rich. It's not so hard being that privileged, I assume. I'll just pretend to feel guilty about it. Lasagna. I'm a-coming.
Madame, the police are here to talk to you.
Oh. Could I hide
the drugs
first?
You probably should not be saying that out loud, monsieur.
Oh, hi.
Hello, ma'am.
Wait for me.
Sorry to bother you, but this is vital to our case. Like, extremely, extremely vital to our case.
What do you think a rich singer like me can help you with?
Well, first of all, I just gotta say that you're quite the singer.
Okay, what does that have to do with anything? You know, you could have called. You didn't have to come all the way down here and interrogate me in person.
Oh, you don't have to tell me how to do my job. I know how to do my job very, very well.
Yeah.
So at the end of the interrogation,
yeah, I was there.
I was just like, you've just been interrogated.
Hey, partner, you coming in?
Alright, hold it, you two. I got a couple questions for you.
I think I can handle this, Clifford. You going on without me.
Oh, was he named after that big red dog?
Well, no.
Oh, I see. So it was the Martin Short character in that one
How
movie.
How did you know about that movie? I've never told anyone about it. It is a pretty good movie, after all. Martin Short.
And yes, Charles Grodin should have gotten an Oscar for putting up with Martin Short.
You and me? We're best friends. Well, see you later.
Wait a minute. I was supposed to capture him.
I got you started.
Oh, this looks nasty.
If this is vegan, I don't want it. I don't want anything that's vegan.
You don't even know what vegan is.
Well, neither do you.
Now you listen up, kids. You're gonna eat it, and you're gonna like this stuff.
And while you guys are eating, I will distract you from your food through all sorts of wonderful stories about my granddaughter.
Do you think milk is vegan? Because I heard a rumor it's vegan.
Humans aren't supposed to drink not dairy milk.
Yeah, I can't drink it. I heard this comes from big almonds, and they just want us to buy more of this stuff.
I'm not eating this milk. Did you hear that dairy cows, they cause enough carbon monoxide that damages the earth?
Do we live on the earth?
Yeah.
Oh.
These people are fascists.
Fascists?
Adults are fascists.
Excuse me, Grandma Mary? What's that? Are you a fascist? Well, I would say we're more communist, because we're all suffering the same meal together.
Oh, okay. Communism is bad, but you know, okay, I guess if everyone agrees, and, no one's doing better than other people.
Well, you know, I grew up in a place where they had fascism. Everyone just kind of did it. It pays to be on the right side of history, I tell you what.
I couldn't agree more, my honey darling.
Foster mom, foster dad.
Don't call us that.
I think my oatmeal's on the fritz again.
Yeah, it's weird. Mine's just the shape of the bowl.
Well, I'm hungry enough to eat anything. I lost another tooth.
Boy forsaken.
fine gentleman. I see you have a young boy.
This is not a boy. This is an orphan. We ran out of room in the shelter, and he needs a home stat.
I cannot just take a boy.
You have a moral obligation to God himself to take this boy. And perhaps we can work something out. He's fuel efficient, low calorie. Come on now.
I guess there's no shame in inviting strangers into my house. Would you guys like some tea or whatever we English do nowadays or back in the days or... So tell me, boy, what are your political leanings?
Boys do not have the right to vote, for they are young children and they do not have brains. Isn't that right, kid? You don't have any brains?
Don't be nervous. Tell the man about your lack of brains.
Go on, child.
No brains whatsoever.
Quite. Well, he is small, and he can fit into small places, and he doesn't have to bend over as much to pick up all your socks or whatever. A couple years ago, you suffered from that Tiny Tim disease, isn't that right?
You mean ADHD?
Wonderful. No. This is quite wonderful indeed. Now, tell me, boy, do you belong to a conservative group or a liberal?
Oh, that's enough right now. You better sign these papers. This boy is all yours. Well, this is happening awfully fast. But okay, I guess when people put paper in front of me, I have to sign it. Here you go. This is my John Hancock.
John Hancock is a terrorist. An American terrorist. But, you know, we're from British.
Okay, boy. You have to be good. See you later.
It looks like he's your problem now.
What an interesting fellow that man is. Perhaps I shall buy that hat when I go to the store next week. My boy, come here, please. Let me take a good look at you. Would you say you're part of the big wig party or the small wig?
I don't recognize either side as viable.
So you're quite a little radical, are you?
Well, not quite exactly.
I'm, bit of a radical myself, young man. Would you like to see my switchblade?
I've seen plenty.
I'm sure you have, you dirty little street rat. Let me ask you something. Would you like to hear my life story?
Please don't tell me your life story.
I was a young man, as young as you, when I decided to become a...
Oh, no, please. Please just stop.
It was the year without a summer. Mount Tambora erupted. It was cold, and so many people died.
Please stop.
Well, come on now. The story's just getting good.
If it's not good from the beginning, it's never gonna be good.
I have a really good idea. I want you to go to the store, buy a pen, I need a pen, and some paper, and you're gonna write these stories down.
Oh no, do I have to? Oh no. Guess I have to find the place.
Now hurry on back. I'll be waiting. So then I said, "Orange, you glad I didn't say banana?"
You don't start a joke at the end. Listen, Cappy, I don't need this kind of sass from you. I'm going through a lot.
Pray tell.
My girlfriend keeps pressuring me to pop the question.
Well, I'm sorry your life is so great.
On the surface, maybe, but not on the inside. I'm very sad, and I'm very having cold feet. I'm having second thoughts about everything these days. My IBS flares up at weird times. I constantly feel like I have to walk on eggshells with her. Well, I heard you laughing. Quit making fun of my dilemma. Okay, love you, bye. Well, now I gotta... Oh! Honey, it's really good to see you.
What's that here about cold feet?
That's ridiculous. I got hot feet.
I know that you're going through some stuff right now.
Oh no, don't worry about me.
You know, I really tried to get those tickets to Hoobastank.
Listen, honey, I don't have to listen to them live.
But you've been wanting these...
Listen, honey, I got plenty of recordings of Hoobastank, and I can listen to them anytime.
No, it's not the same.
My whole life, I've only had one love, until I met you, and now I have two loves.
I just hate the thought that you're blaming me for not getting tickets to the concert.
No, wait, honey, that's nonsense. Come on, don't get all sad.
But I feel bad because you wanted to get that t-shirt sign of the original spelling of Hoobastank with a U, instead of what it is today with an A.
Yeah, that would have been really great.
It's just so difficult to please you, and I know that you only have one love, and I really just let you down on that.
Whether you buy Hoopastank or you don't get Hoopastank, as long as you love Hoopastank as much as I do, I will love you just as much.
But not more than Hoopastank?
Oh.
I can tell by your reaction that you'll never love me more. This really sucks. Far be it from me, I'm going to stand in the way of your true love.
Honey, honey, life isn't an or, it's an and. And also, could you pick up my dry cleaning for me?
Well, this isn't really the time
to... Well, it's the least you can do forgetting about the tickets.
I suppose I could, but I'm not happy about it one bit.
Who gives a damn if you're happy or not?
Kate!
Awkward!
Why don't you just mind your
really
business,
gonna cut
okay?
You.
Well, pardon me, young lovers. I just have a job to... Hello, I would like 3 tickets to the Rockettes tonight. If you wouldn't mind.
Come on, honey, let's get out of here.
I'm just gonna stand
yes,
out on this window,
all 3
okay?
tickets are just for me. I need space on either side of the seats. I plan to have a big bucket of popcorn filled with candy, and on the other side, I'll have all the drinks that I could ever... Owie!
All right, let's get out of here. We don't need to deal with this sass.
Hello? Hello, anyone there? Hello?
Oh, no, no, no. Do not worry about me. I was just distracting the lover's quarrel. After all, I'm just here to get tickets to the Rockettes.
Oh, so what you're saying is that I can purchase 5 tickets with a purchase of 4, so that means I can bring my pets to the show. I love it when things work out.
Well, according to this graph, you have a very obnoxious personality. I've been doing the research for a long time now. Why, you ask? Well, it's out of spite. Listen, I gotta... Yeah, no. I'm not gonna talk to you while you're like this. Bye. Hello, I'm your Kirk Douglas impersonator. Whoa. You're striking. I think we just found our man.
Well, thank you very much. I got my brothers to punch me in the face.
Well, your bone structure's held up pretty well.
Well, so do I got the job?
Well... Well, let's try your impersonation of Kirk Douglas, after all. So, tell me, are you Spartacus? Or are you not Spartacus? Come on, it's a simple question.
I am Spartacus. I always thought that name was very adorable, because it starts with a Spart and ends in a kiss. But I digress.
Well, you sound pretty good to me. As long as you look the part, you know, it doesn't really matter what you say, after all.
Would I be expected to talk?
Well, yes, of course.
What would I say, then?
Well, you would say your most famous lines, not counting the ones that were written by the Hollywood Eight, you know, those communists.
Well, aren't those the best lines?
Well, listen, I have to be a little more forthcoming when it comes to this position and this job, so we're not necessarily looking in for a personator, per se. We're looking for more of a replacement.
Do you actually think I can replace him?
Well, of course. Maybe.
Well, I like to think of myself as a method actor. I like to go deep into the roles.
Don't you know that method actors are just impersonators? It's just a fancy word of saying it.
I'm an actor.
If you say so. Listen. I'm not looking for perfection.
Well, I'm above this.
Okay, there's the door. Whoa, wait. Hold on a minute. You passed the test. Congratulations, Kirk. I need to reveal some truths to you, and I'm a method actor, too.
Oh, you old so-and-so, I know you're one of us. And thus I started my career as a method actor. Whoa, well, hello there, young man. I got a couple questions. Well, why didn't you tell me a little bit about yourself?
Smoking's bad.
Sorry about the bad first impression.
I told the other scouts I don't want to be a James Dean look-alike. It's just awful.
Well, the country's in mourning. We just lost James Dean, and we need a replacement.
And so you decided to go to prison to find me.
Well, you found us, kid. Do you happen to realize how much you look like James Dean? I can tell by your look that you're shocked.
I'm not shocked. You think you're the first person to come to me?
No, as soon as your mugshot hit the papers, everyone started hitting the pavement to get to you.
I think acting's for losers who have no life.
That may be true,
What's that supposed to mean? What do you mean by that?
I know what it's like to be a loser. I was a loser my whole life.
No, not as big a loser as me. I'm leaving. I don't need this crap. I am not an actor. And I never will be. I'm a very complex person who has lots of passionates. And I don't need you.
Officer?
I don't need anybody. I can do my own thing. I'm going to be a used car salesman. I'm going to do all sorts of normal purple things. All
right, come
I'm
with me.
I'm
going
to do aluminum sheeting on housing. You're not going to tell me what to do.
Come on.
You're going to get out of here.
Come on.
And I never want to see your face around here again.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Get out.
Did he say passionates? Getting stuck in this room. Ugh, this guy over here.
You know it.
How long do you expect us to wait like this?
As long as it takes.
Kids' birthday parties are such a sham.
Oh, excuse me?
We must not forget the greatest birthday of all.
Ah, I know what you're talking about.
And besides, we got a nice wreath for them.
It is pretty nice.
See? Look how beautiful it is. Lots of flowers and stuff.
Yeah, I get it. Flowers and stuff.
You pay quite a penny for this thing. Seems like you're trying a little hard on a single mother's child.
The birth of any child is very special.
Yeah.
As common courtesy, I will let you... How could you do something like that?
Listen, fellas, we can't stay here for too long. The storms are coming. We can't stay here for too long. Let's think about our next option.
Why do I even bother with you two?
We might have to run for it.
We just have to stay quiet.
I told you this was a bad place to hide. Now come on, let's get going. Whoop-a-doop-boo. Sneak, sneak, sneak. A sneak, sneak, sneak. Make sure nobody sees me. A sneak, sneak, sneak. A sneak, sneak, sneak. A sneak!
It's too bright.
Will you keep it down?
I'm trying my best to relax, okay? I've had a bad day. First I stubbed my toe, I lost my favorite sock, and then I found my favorite sock in my pants, but then I have 3 pairs of socks and only have 2 feet. This is ridiculous, I hate it!
Yeah, you got problems. Can you just go to sleep?
You know, I'm really surprised that you can even sleep in this thunder.
Well, it'd be a lot easier if it was darker in here.
Would you like me to play some soothing music?
Like what? Jazz?
Very funny. I'm gonna play something like Hoobastank, if you don't mind. It's a good band. They have some great songs. I Found a Reason for You, Crawling in the Dark, and other things.
Oh, you can't be serious. That's a horrible band.
Well, they were formed in the 90s, and they still are pretty active.
Well, if they're so active, how come they haven't made anything?
Well, of course they've made things. They've made all sorts of music and stuff.
But anything of noteworthy?
I happen to know that they released a song on YouTube just recently, and it's pretty good. Doesn't sound too much like a lot of their old stuff, but still, I think it's pretty good.
Oh, please. No, let me take the light.
Rain, go away. Come back another day. For today is a new day. Even though it's 3 a.m, I can expect that this rain will stop.
Listen, we have 2 beautiful, independent people here who happen to share a life sometimes. Sure, some people may call it a marriage contract, but is it quite necessary for people to actually abide by that contract? Because there's that moral obligation when it comes to marriage, after all. And who's to say who has more to lose? The loveless marriage or
the money? I don't think that's appropriate here.
My darling daughter, how are you today? Not so well? Well, that's what happens. Well, sometimes people have good days, and sometimes people have bad days.
That's enough of that.
You know, one might say, happy wife, happy life, and it works.
Well, it works for me.
And only you?
Oh! Oh, no, of course not. Happy has been. Happy fun can? Well, I can't think of anything that rhymes.
And yet we find ourselves at an impasse between you two. So my happiness means nothing to anybody? Stomp my feet, put my foot down, point my finger, and just everything can be okay?
Well,
yeah.
Oh.
Well, luckily for you, in the 40s, men's life expectancy is down really low.
Oh,
I mean, I'm not as sure it's associated with poor health, retirement.
I'm retired. Do you think I'm going to die anytime now?
Don't you talk to him like that. He's trying to help me with my stuff. Well, there always seems to be a common theme between retirement and the tomb. Are you saying that my father-in-law might die? Okay, let's not get carried away. Let me just sit down. I'm going to go talk to your father-in-law for a second here. Oh, fine. The real men are speaking. Oh, let me just have my platform for a second at least. Ever since you came here, you've been sassing me like crazy. I don't need that kind of sass from people. My father-in-law gives it to me. My mom gives it to me. My wife gives it to me. Everyone gives me sass, no matter where I go. And frankly, I am sick and I'm tired of this. Now get out of my house or go wherever. Get some ice cream. I'm gonna just go and touch things. Duck, duck, duck. Goose. Oh, I'll sit down. Does he usually have tantrums like this?
Maybe?
Well, I think your husband suffers from restless arm syndrome.
Well, that sounds right. After all, you did say syndrome after it. I'm gonna go, I'm gonna go powder my nose.
Am I still in trouble? Meanwhile, and not in the MCU.
Boop-a-doop-boop, boop-boop-boop, ding-dong.
Wait a minute. I don't remember ordering any pizza. Wait a minute. It's not my birthday, is it?
Somebody told me to bring this hat box over here.
Well, I don't want to be rude. Why don't you come on in? Let me grab some of your stuff. Make yourself at home. Hold on a second. You're not trying to catfish me, are you? Because I already paid my dues to the Merchant Marines. Let me take that hat box off your chest.
Wow, you really do have a beautiful home. I like how it just kind of opens up and it's like, wow, this is a lot bigger than what you'd see on the street and whatnot.
Huh? My hands are cold. I see you got a lot of stuff that you just keep on putting on your shoulder for me to grab from you.
If God made women with more arms, they wouldn't need men.
You can leave the gloves on ottoman. I can pick them up later and possibly use them.
Oh yes, I definitely plan on losing quite a few things while I'm here. But not the kind of things that you think I'd lose. After all, you know, I brought a lot of stuff. But not as much stuff as you.
I beg your pardon, but I bought all this stuff myself.
Well, maybe I do beg your pardon.
Well, that's quite the comeback. I'm gonna sip on my tea.
With such a big house, you might have...
Oh, I beg your pardon? I can't understand you when I'm sipping tea. But I could be losing my hearing, knock on wood.
Now that wood sounded exotic.
Well, it is one of a kind. It's made of ducks.
Hmm.
Hence the duck sound. Oh, that's right. I forgot to have breakfast.
Well, if you have a kitchen hidden away in here, I can make you eggs.
No, that sounds like a terrible idea.
And that was the day I decided to open my own restaurant. Here's a couple customers that are just coming in right now. I'm gonna go talk to them.
Hi, dears. Well, come on in. We're gonna get you a table, and you can
Quit doing your job exactly like you're supposed to. How are you guys doing? You look like a fine young couple. Oh, yes, we're a fine young couple on the outside. Oh, yes, I remember being young and in a couple, but now, things change. As you can see here, there's been a lot of caricatures on the walls. Darling, why don't you just take care of them? I'm just gonna be over here.
As you can see, that was the owner. She's pretty great.
Yeah, I'm over here at the bar. Have I ever told you all my bar stories? Look at me, I'm in my pink. I'm talking over here. Now let's get back to that story.
Do you know what I absolutely hate? I hate it when people just grab a book right on from under me.
A Tale of Three Villages.
Again with this?
It was the best western of times. It was the decibels and hertz of times. Back in the day, it was like this and that, and I was just a boy, just minding his own business when, oh man, old Sally Sue was all like, hey, what's going on? I just want to have a good time. Well, so what'll it be?
Well, I could really use a good cappuccino.
Oh, couldn't we all?
Oh, wow,
That story over there is getting really boring. I better come in and freshen things up. Don't mind my swagger. I'm gonna be right around here. Could you get out of here? I'm just gonna be doing my thing here. I can help these guys. All right, bye. Sorry about that confusion over there. I'll be glad to help you. I'll even be at your table, ruining your date, being a third wheel. Everybody knows that a third wheel is a lot more stable than two wheels. I don't mind another person poking and prodding our relationship.
Suppose this is the closest thing we'll get to a Black Widow movie, huh?
So this is Washington. See, there's the Capitol building. Ha ha ha! You guys look like a fine young couple.
Really? You're already doing this out of the gate?
We're gonna call a cab soon, and we just don't need this.
I just wanted to say how refreshing it is that—
Well, negative or positive, you can't just talk to random people who are just not interested. You know what I'm saying? Respectfully.
Come on, let's get going. I gotta get out of here anyways.
Please accept my apology, past, present, and future.
I like the sound of that.
Alright, let's find a payphone.
Oh, I forgot it's the 70s.
Let's use the specifically lit payphone.
Alright, you go ahead. I'm gonna sit down on these steps.
Well, good thing I have changed this time, because my parents are sick and tired of me calling collect.
I thought you were calling a cab.
Well, cab's the name of my father, and my mother's name is also cab. Excuse me. Hi, I'm sorry to call so late, but me and my, boyfriend need a ride. Well, of course, Chuck. Who else? Well, it was my idea to stay out extra late tonight. It is Washington, D.C.
It's also dangerous there, you know where I go?
Well, yeah, I know it's dangerous, but that's why I'm calling you.
Are you?
It's perfectly fine. Come on, just pick us up. We're outside the Capitol building.
Ugh.
There's a full moon and everything, lighting everything up very specifically.
Hey. Do you want me to talk to them for me?
Hold on a second.
What's the holdup?
Oh, well, you know, my family always has to hear the backstory and every little detail about every little thing.
I heard that.
But, you know, it's coming through. They'll be helping us shortly. Oh, no. Oh, my God! Look out!
Listen, buddy, I'm next in line for the phone. You better get out of here.
But this is an emergency.
No!
Oh, God! Come on, just let me use the phone for a second.
No.
It's no big deal.
Oh, my God! Oh, jeez!
I just want to use the phone! Let me in! Come on, now!
I'm not done using the phone! Get away from me! Get out of here!
I'm just a fun part dog!
No.
I'm very friendly!
I'm not gonna let you use the phone! I gotta finish my phone call! Stop!
Come on, come on, let me in! I just
want
to talk on the
phone! Stop!
I'm next in line anyways, but they all
I heard you look at the world with a new perspective, but this is ridiculous!
Come on,
Gross.
Now!
Get out of here! I don't want this!
What's a big deal? Come on,
no.
Now! Let
no,
me use the
no,
phone.
Means, no, get out of here!
I'll be quick! It's no big deal!
No! I'm not finished my own phone call!
Come on,
get out of here! There's another payphone to block away! What's the big deal? Get out of here!
Did you just say another payphone? Come on, now! You
can
tell me!
I tell you, if you calm down, get in! I have a phone!
Would you say it's closer to the Washington Monument or Lincoln Memorial?
Neither.
I just need to know. Just tell me.
Okay, okay. It's near the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier. Get out of here. Just
go. Oh, but that's so far away. Oh, well. I'm part dog. I can enjoy the run.